go down now to the field for the opening coin toss. Mel's Park has won the toss. They have deferred and deflected to defend the north goal line. They will kick off to Lakewood. Interesting strategy, Mike. Let's go now with the starting lineups for today's game. Starting offense for Pinellas Park, the quarterback is Booker, the backfield is Sheffield Harris, wide receiver Holmes, and the flanker is Vaughn. Left tackle is Wade, Samuels the guard, the center Mensel, Hansford the guard, Heiken the tackle, and Stratton the tight end. Lakewood Spartans defensive front, Thornton, Logan, Dixon, and Boldick. The linebacking core, Thornton, Rollins, and Edwards. Offensive backfield, Jordan, Myrick, Martin, and Allen. Offensive backfield for the Lakewood Spartans. Carter, the quarterback, Fletcher, Rollins, Floyd, and Swain. Clark, Cinnamon, Graham, Logan, Cameron, and Boldick on the offensive line. Pinellas Park defensive line, Harris, McNeil is out with an injury. Gaskin, Grissinger, and Geiger. Yeager, Lassiter, and Blasiola, the linebacking core, and the secondary. Ashcraft, McLean, Straw, and Crenny. Getting ready to kick off for Pinellas Park. Kevin Gressinger, number 11. Young man who also plays defensive tackle, one of the leading tacklers on the defensive squad for the Patriots. Back deep for Lakewood. Number 25, Reggie Franklin.
Franklin's another member of the deep running back group that Lakewood Spartans have. He's an outstanding runner and provides some good depth should anything happen to Fletcher or Floyd.
And we are underway. Spiral kickoff coming down to number 4, the short man. That is Edwards. Edwards to the outside. Stacked up, and Lakewood will take over first and 10 from their own 24. They will run a wishbone. They probably are a little more wide open, Mike, in their wishbone than Clearwater. Don't quite have the size in the offensive line that the Clearwater Tornadoes have, so they try to utilize their speed a little more.
They've done that so very effectively this season. Tom Carter coming out there, number 5. He took over the quarterback job late last season after Swain had been there. Gary Alderman had quarterbacked the team for a while, but Carter showed a lot of promise, and he's had an outstanding 1988.
The backs are Floyd, Fletcher, and Rollins. The quarterback is Carter, the young man that Mike just spoke of. Carter straight back on play action under heavy pressure. And he is going to be spun around and sacked finally. Good pressure initially in there from number 83, Shannon Harris. This is Harris's first start. Mike, he's a transfer student. He has replaced the injured Dave McNeil. He got off to a good start right there.
And good job by the Patriot defense. They were ready for that pass. You'd think the Spartans would try to start off with a run. But Carter, good coverage also by the Patriot secondary, and he's tackled for the loss.
Tom Geiger also in there along with number 22, Sean Crenny. They are the men that finished off the play. It's a big loss on the play. It'll bring up second down now, and we'll call it 22. They'll break the bone. Wide receivers to either side. Two tight ends. Straight handoff. Number 27, Floyd has a lot of running room into the secondary. He has one man to beat. It's a foot race, and they're going to drag him down from behind at the 33. There is a flag on the play back at the 28-yard line, and I believe it's going to come back for an illegal block, but there's the explosiveness right there of the Spartans of Lakewood, Mike. They showed their speed on that play.
What set that up was an outstanding block by Bill Logan, number 67, on 42, Rich Blasioli.
Crenny coming from behind to run him down. The 4.6 speed of William Floyd, number 27, the fullback. He has 236 yards on the year and 31 carries and 3 touchdowns. Of course, the Lakewood bench right here in front of you can hear them yelling. They thought it was a good block, and from here, we can play that back one more time if Linda Baynard, our instant replay operator, will cue that back up for us. They called it a clip. It was pretty close, it looked like, from here. Going to march them back to second down. We'll wait for after this play to try to bring that back. Second down, and it's going to remain 21. March back from the spot of the infraction. The wishbone. This is number 21. Rollins, dropping there, fumbled the football. It looks like, and it is, Pinellas Park is on it, like a big break early for the Patriots. Number 46 in there, Troy Lassiter apparently recovered the fumble for Coach Bruce Buck's Pinellas Park Patriots.
What a big turnaround. Instead of the Spartans having the ball way downfield, the penalty and then the fumble, and the Patriots have another great chance to get back on the lead.
They will take over first and 10 from the 11-yard line. There's the last play right here. Ball was stripped inside. Looked like Lassiter stripped it and then recovered it. You can't do any more than that. The fine freshman linebacker in the I formation. Rico Harris off left tackle into the secondary. He'll be down to about the 3-yard line. It'll be second down and two from there. Good one-on-one stick in the secondary by number two, LaDarren Allen, or it would have been a touchdown for Rico Harris.
One of the big questions for the Patriots this season was they had to rebuild that entire offensive line, but Rico Harris and Sheffield and Booker, they've done a good job. Their statistics have certainly proven the offensive line has done a good job this year.
And a good hole right there off the left side. 8-yard gain on first down. It's second down and two. The ball at the 3. In the I formation. Have an encroachment penalty. We'll see which squad it will be called against. I believe it's going to be called against Lakewood Person High School football. Encroachment is offsides. That is the correct terminology. That marks them half the distance to the goal line. Took them up inches shy of a first down. They can get a first down here without scoring. Second down and very short, and they're only about a yard and a half away from the end zone.
That's really a crucial penalty.
Have two tight ends, wing left, the I formation with Sheffield, and Harris is the tailback. Fumbled the snap, and Booker comes up with it. He's going to try to wedge it across. Looked like he may have bobbled that snap. He didn't really fumble it, Mike. Good presence of mind to just try to spin forward and follow his blockers, but he's going to be shy, apparently. No, he's going to have his first down. It'll be first and goal now from inside the one.
Good recovery by Booker to grab hold onto the ball and then try to get ahead. He did get the first down. Now the Patriots with four good chances to punch it in.
I want to mention here that the clock and scoreboard are not operating here at Spartan Stadium. So we will be at a minor disadvantage as the game progresses. We will not know how much time is left in the quarters. We'll try to get the indication from the officials on the field. First and goal. Booker, quarterback sneak. He's stuffed, but they're going to say his forward progress got him into the end zone. Just into the first quarter. Quarterback sneak by wonderful Booker puts Pinellas Park up by the score of 6-0. Happened on the big, after the big fumble recovery at the 11-yard line. Stripping the ball was Troy Lassiter, the linebacker. He made the recovery for the Patriots.
Spartans got great penetration. Todd Thornton helped throw him back, but again, that forward momentum, just enough for the TD.
Devin Gressinger, the senior kicker, number 11 on. It is up, and it is through. 7-0 now, Pinellas Park. Early in the first quarter, Lakewood Spartans have defeated Largo by the score of 17-10 in their opener. They defeated a tough Osceola team, of course, Largo, a very tough team also this year, by the score of 17-13. That was the Osceola score. And they defeated Gainesville 23-8. Pinellas Park opened with a big win at St. Petersburg by the score of 17-3. Lost a tough one at Largo, 7-0. And then, of course, last week's game we had here on Vision Cable Channel 9, they lost 31-19 to the Clearwater Tornadoes. In a game, Mike, that they feel they could have won if they would have had better play on the special teams.
And you remember last week, very similar scenario. They recovered a Clearwater turnover, and they punched it in for a touchdown.
Gressinger will kick off for the second time. Back deep again is Fleming. Number 25, Reggie Franklin. He's a 5'8 junior. Gressinger, another good kick. Franklin at his 4. Straight up the middle. Has some room. And he's going to finally be dragged down. Now he's going to break out of that tackle. It's Gressinger, the kicker, against Franklin. Franklin is going to take it. 96 yards for the touchdown. Unbelievable effort, Reggie Franklin. Looked like they were going to drag him down at midfield. He kept those legs turning and just ran right out of the tackle. And just that quickly, the Spartans of Lakewood answer back.
Talked about Richard Straw opening kickoff.
He's got great ability, tough runner inside. You'll see him take it up the middle. You also see number 32, West Straw, appear to have him stopped on a nice play there, as the extra point's good. Somehow, Franklin got away from West Straw and just continued to go. He didn't seem to lose any speed.
That was Robbie Dobbs, 5'10 senior, left footer in there to add the extra point. And we are tied at 7 in an exciting first quarter, just into the first quarter of action.
Perhaps we could see that return again. You can see the great breaking of tackle by Reggie Franklin, because I really thought he'd be stopped here by Straw.
This was set up all the way up the middle. Mike, good wedge blocking.
Exactly, look at that hole right there, and then he cuts it sharply back out there. Now here's Straw, had his jersey in his hand, but Franklin just pulls away. And then he beats Gressinger right there, and he's in there for TD.
Franklin Shea is not just a sprinter. He's got strong legs because he ran right through the tackle of a player that weighs a lot more than him.
And once again, a play on special teams has hurt the Pinellas Park Patriots.
Here's the kick coming down to Booker at his 18. Booker trying to get it to the outside, has some room. Cuts it back, and he's going to finally get tripped up at the 40 on a vicious hit by number 9, that is Gary Alderman. But wonderful Booker with a good return for Pinellas Park will put his team in excellent field position, first and 10 at their own 40.
You don't often see your quarterback returning kick, but when you have someone the talent of wonderful Booker, you let him return it. You can see he cuts it to the outside, nice blocking. And he picks it up for the nice return, and the Patriots have nice field position for their second drive.
Jason White, number 10, was the man that kicked off that time for the Spartans. In the I formation. Wing left, two tight ends. In the I formation, that is Harris. This is Harris. Off the left side, we'll pick up about 3 yards on first down. Mike, interesting strategy here offensively. They are lining up early in this game with two tight ends and a wing back. Looks like they are going to try to play power football against that defensive front of Lakewood.
It's going to be a very interesting strategy. We saw last week Patriots were able to move the ball on the ground against a bigger Clearwater team, against a bigger Tornado team. And so far tonight, on their running plays, they've been able to pick up some good yardage.
Again with a double tight end, ball on the left hash market, second down and 6. This is Sheffield up the middle. Nothing there. He's stuffed right in the middle of the action by the defensive front of the Spartans. On the bottom of that pile was number 67, Bill Logan. Bill is a 5'11", 180-pound junior playing on the defensive line. Here is again.
Also coming in was Patrick Rollins, number 22, and they stopped that play before it could get started.
Patrick Rollins, a 5'7", 176-pound senior, doubles as a linebacker and a running back. Coach Bob Stevens. Bob Stevens in his 13th year here at Lakewood. Overall record is 72-55. Our formation is now third down and 8. Booker back to pass under pressure. Breaks out of it. Ball is loose. He comes up with it, and it's going to bring up fourth down. He gains a yard and a half after all that. Broke through the initial pressure of the defensive front. The ball was stripped. It bounced right back to him. Picked up 2 yards and they have fourth down and 5 in a punting situation for the Patriots.
Patriots very fortunate to get that ball back. Ball stripped while Booker was spinning. You'll see here good pressure by the Spartans. They turn him inside and the ball stripped away by Logan, but right back to wonderful Booker.
They're lining up on fourth and 5 as though they're going to go for it. They did this last week against Clearwater. Appears like they are. Maybe they're going to try to draw them offsides defensively with the long count. That's what they're going to do. They're going to call timeout right now. The strategy did not work. It was good scouting by the Lakewood staff. Had their team prepared for this. And now they will call the timeout and go back in punt formation.
And this is where the Patriots had so much difficulty last week on the punt formation. Their special teams has already allowed that long touchdown run.
With the timeout in the action, the coaches are out speaking to their squad. He joined us at 7-7 early in the first quarter. Wonderful Booker, after a fumble, scored on a 1-yard quarterback sneak for Pinellas Park, put them up 7-0. On the ensuing kickoff, Reggie Franklin broke it 96 yards with a tying touchdown. And that is where we stand right now in the first quarter. Booker back in punt formation. Left puts it out of there. Ball will bounce at the 24 and roll dead inside the 20. Lakewood will take over first and 10 from their own 18. Back deep that time for Lakewood was number 8, Bill Swain, the outstanding wide receiver. He is a junior. Bill leads the squad in receptions with 6, has 155 yards and 1 touchdown.
I think you have to give Bob Stevens a lot of credit. Last year, the Spartans just 2-8, but he knew he had a lot of talent from the junior varsity teams, and he let the players stay there and develop. And now the players are with the varsity team, and you can see the results.
First and 10 for Lakewood from their own 18. They're going to spread out of the wishbone again. One back offense. Carter is the quarterback. This is Floyd off the right side. Has some running room. Will turn it up and still drive his legs for a 16-yard gain. Make that on first down. William Floyd, the fine 6'1", 188-pound junior fullback. Mike, that right there is why he's the leading rusher on this squad. He's not only a power runner, he's got a good burst of speed.
Same play we saw before that was nullified by a penalty as Bill Logan came out there, delivers a nice block. Actually, Blasioli just fall down on his own, but Floyd picks up the first down.
With that kickoff return, Mike, Reggie Franklin has set a school record. He broke a record set back in 1970 by Steve Torrey and also in 76 by James Thomas. This is Floyd stuffed in the backfield for a loss of a yard. The longest was 95 yards. We're going to give him 96 on that because his foot was inside the 5-yard line when he received it. So an individual school record for Reggie Franklin on that kickoff return of 96 yards. Buck over on the sideline for the Patriots of Pinellas Park. Bruce is feeling a little better, a little under the weather today. Second down and 11. The ball at their own 34. Lakewood comes out, one back, two tight ends. Flankers to either side. This is play action. Carter looking deep, has Swain out here, and good coverage by Ashcraft. Both players tripped going for the football. But that was number 15, Damian Ashcraft, and we heard last week he has 4-5 speed, and he is a Division I prospect at a cornerback. He's 6'3", 178 pounds, and that's a great size for a cornerback, and he's got good speed. He showed that good man coverage on that play, Mike.
Patriots had the blitz on in their case of incidental contact, no call. Nice, pretty nice double block, you know, by the Spartans on that blitz. Carter did have a few seconds to release the football.
It's third down now and 11. Still in the first quarter of action. We are tied at 7. Lakewood against Pinellas Park. Boldick comes wide to the right in the wishbone. Carter on the counter option, pitches it. It's a loose football. Franklin will pick it up. He's going to be in big trouble, however, and he's going to lose about 10 yards on the play. The counter option, they faked one side, turned to the other side, but as soon as he turned, he was popped, pitched the ball, tried to make a quick pitch, but it was a loose football, good defensive pressure off the right side of the Pinellas Park defensive line.
Excellent pursuit, that's how you defeat the wishbone, and now they should get pretty good field position out of this punt. Last year, these two teams had a wild 30-28 game with the Patriots coming out on top.
Robbie Dobbs, number 22, into punt. Standing at his own 12. It's a low kick. Sheffield is the deep man. And will roll out of bounds at the 44-yard line of Pinellas Park. They will take over first and 10. So after the long kickoff return, Pinellas Park comes out and plays good defense, forcing Lakewood to punt. And this game, after the explosive first couple of minutes, Mike, has settled down. Both defensive squads are doing a good job on their last possessions.
We should add, though, also, Brian, that the wind tonight, there's a brisk wind blowing, and it's blowing for the Patriots on this particular drive.
Blowing north to south here. Takes the ball back to Harris, and tripped up at the line of scrimmage, or may have had more yards than that. He's going to pick up about 3 yards on the play. That'll bring up second down 7. Of course, Rico Harris with the explosive 4.3 40 speed, fine senior running back.
Maybe the best athlete on the entire football team for the Patriots.
He's averaging 6.7 yards per carry. Replay. Again in the eye formation. This time they're going to send the wide receiver to this side of the field. Gets the ball to Harris to the wide side. Trying to cut it back and will be dragged down after a gain of about 2 yards on the play. And that will bring up third down and five. Over there was number 90, Ed Dixon, one of the first men over there, 6'4", junior defensive end. And Norman Boldick also in there at number 89.
Boldick made some play, Brian. He was being double blocked, but he managed to defeat the block and get a hand and make the play. Let's take a look at it again. You'll see he's been blocked there, but he gets his hands on the attack and it makes the tackle.
Boldick made the big play. It's now third down and five in the I formation. Again, Harris to the right side. Nothing there. Stuffed in the backfield. Again, excellent penetration by the Spartans of Lakewood. John Tate Edwards was in there. Bill Logan also in there, along with a host of the Spartans. We're not fooled at all on that play. We mentioned Pinellas Park trying to run the power football and has not been successful on the last couple of downs for them. Booker into punt. Good high kick. Coming down to Swain. Fumbles it off his shoulder pads. It'll go out of bounds, and the Spartans will retain possession. They'll put it in play first and 10 from their own 16.
Lakewood get a big break there. Swain, the ball bounced off him, but right out of bounds.
He may have lost that load up there on his lights, but he misjudged the timing of it. It came down hitting on top of the shoulder pad. Referee for today's game is Jerry Simpson. And we're going to take a break right now. That is the end of the first quarter. We'll pick up with the referees when we come back for second quarter action. The score is 7-7. Stay with us. Welcome back to Spartan Stadium. Brian Unks along with Mike Rhodes starting the second quarter. First and 10 from Lakewood for their own, 16. Up the middle, big yardage, close to a first down. It's number 24. Number 34 make that on the carry. That's Jason Fletcher, the fine senior running back. It's got to be short or they're going to measure him. They're going to say he has his first down now. Good Fletcher again.
Good job of hitting the hole. The fake worked and they're close to the first down.
You just joined us at 7-7, Pinellas Park versus Lakewood. Division Cable 9's high school football game of the week. First and 10 from the 26-yard line of Lakewood. This is Fletcher again off the right side. Tripped up at the line of scrimmage. Will dive forward for about 4 yards. It'll set up second down and six. Number 42 on the bottom of the pile was Rich Blasioli, fine senior linebacker for the Patriots.
Of course, this is a non-district game. The Spartans have district contests coming up with St. Pete, Bocasiega, Gibbs, and Dixie Hollins, and you'd think that St. Petersburg or Bocasiega would be the most difficult teams. St. Pete they have here at Spartan Stadium and the Pirates away, but right now Lakewood looking good to perhaps win the district since they've already defeated the Osceola Warriors. And of course this year, Brian, the 4A-10 winner will host the first playoff game at home.
Second down and five in the I formation. Pitch the ball this way. This is Fletcher trying to get outside. Has a great block on the corner into the secondary. Cranny trying to run him down. He pulls him out of bounds at the 35. Got a great block out there. I believe it was Boldick that threw the block. We'll bring it back and take a look at it. We heard how quick they were, Mike, and they had shown it early in this football game.
And it's so important for the other backs in the wishbone to block and block effectively. And that time we're going to see an excellent block thrown by number 27, William Floyd, right there leading the block. And that springs Fletcher for this big game.
That was Floyd. He just pancaked his man, took him right out of the play. Back to the live action. First and 10 from the 35. This is Floyd up the middle, has some room, running hard. Close to a first down. I believe he'll be about a yard shy. It'll bring up second down and one. The big fullback who just threw a crushing block to spring Fletcher for a big gain. That's a nice 9 yard gain on first down. Pinellas Park will call timeout, wisely so. Right now their defense is a little confused. And good yardage on the last couple of plays by the Spartans of Lakewood. Referee for tonight's game is Jerry Simpson. The umpire is Dick McCreary. The line judge is Tom Schutte. Side judge is Bill Simpson. Back judge is Jeff Rich. And the clock operator who was down working it on the field is John Slaughter, because we do not have an operating scoreboard or clock. And Sports Beat, Mike, show you're familiar with here on WBC-TV Channel 9. Tell the folks a little bit about that.
Well, coming up this Monday at 7:30, we'll have the latest news about the reclassification by the Florida High School Activities Association, how that will affect high school sports as well. Highlights from the Rotary Invitational Swim Meet at Clearwater High School. Of course, all the local sports action from both the high schools and the community here in Pinellas County.
Sports Beat every Monday night. Thad Starling, an offensive coach out there, talking to his Patriot defensive squad, trying to get them back in the flow of things here. Lakewood looking very impressive. This time they'll be in the wishbone. Swain, wide receiver to the short side. This is Fletcher into the secondary. Cuts it to the outside, gets a block, and will be driven out of bounds at the 4-yard line. Lakewood Spartans are on the move. Three big plays have taken them about 55 yards. And they are just chewing up the yardage on the ground.
Not only do you have to be impressed with the running of Fletcher and Floyd, but the blocking, left side of the line, a big hole. And Fletcher all the way down to the four. It's Lakewood going in for another touchdown.
Jason Fletcher, 5'10", 162-pound senior, was not a starter tonight. But he's had a big game here in this second quarter. In the wishbone, this is Fletcher to the right side. Cuts it up inside, trying to wedge to the goal line. He's going to be about a yard shy. Good defensive fill by the secondary that time of the Pinellas Park Patriots. On the bottom of the pile, number 48, Mark Page, junior linebacker. Here's the play again.
Fletcher appeared to be going in here, but nice fill there by the Patriot defense, and ball at the one right now.
Swain checks in with the play. He'll line up at the left halfback position. Unbalanced to the right. This is Carter on play action. We'll try to run it in. He will. Got a good block over there by number 67, Bill Logan, the pulling guard. Carter takes it 1 yards for the 1 yard for the touchdown. Make that. It's 13-7 now, favor of Lakewood.
So the Spartans, again, very impressive. Carter cut it back inside, and now the Spartans can have the lead going for the extra point.
Thank you.
This is Jason White, the senior place kicker. And the snap is no good. White's going to try to throw it and cannot get it off. The snap was fumbled by the holder Dobbs, and it'll remain 13-7 in favor of Lakewood here early in the second quarter. An impressive drive.
There's the fake, and Carter just turns it back inside for the easy touchdown.
Again, what made that, Mike, was the good ball fake to the running back. Both the running back and quarterback carried it out, and a good kick-out block by the pulling guard, Billy Logan, the 5'11", 180-pound junior. 13-7, the Lakewood Spartans lead Pinellas Park. Looking like a little bit like the game we had last week, Mike, both teams up and down the field after some turnovers and some big plays. Now we'll see if Pinellas Park can bounce back early in this game like they did last week against the Tornadoes of Clearwater.
Well, Pinellas Park had the momentum after recovering the turnover. They went in for the touchdown, but 20 seconds later, they had a long kickoff return, and that may have taken some of the momentum away from them. And now Lakewood controlling the ball, the line of scrimmage, and they drove it downfield and now lead by 7.
Tom Carter taking it over from a yard out. Tom is a double threat. 206 yards rushing coming into this game. Outstanding 4.440 speed. Also thrown one touchdown pass.
I think we'll see, speaking of pass, I think we'll see the Patriots pass more when they receive the ball here.
This is Dobbs. Good long kickoff coming down to Vaughn at his 5. And he'll wedge it out across the 20. He'll be down at his own 23. The Patriots will take over first and 10 from there. Again, if you've just joined us, it's 13-7. Lakewood leads Pinellas Park. We do not have an operating clock or scoreboard, so we don't know how much time is left. I believe it's about halfway through the second quarter. There you see Robbie Dobbs, the fine senior place kicker. Dobbs is the man who will kick off and kick the long field goal attempts. Jason White is the man who is a little more accurate and will kick the shorter field goals and probably most of the extra points.
Of course, remember the Patriots are now going against the wind.
This time they will have split backs with two tight ends, wing to the right.
on the counter. Harris into the secondary, makes a good move to the outside, has one man to beat, and he'll drag him down at his own 45. Good defensive close light by LeDarren Allen, the 6'3", 192-pound senior. If Allen hadn't gotten over there, Mike, Harris was off to the races.
Allen had the angle, and he cut off Harris just in time, but Rico Harris makes a fine cut here, the quick handoff. Makes a fine play, and now the Patriots have that first down.
They will have it first and 10 from their own 46. Split backs again with two tight ends. Bland is the wing to the right, fumble the snap. Lakewood says they have it. And the referees concur, a late signal from the officials. It came right up to the Lakewood band, and there is another big break. Just when Pinellas Park looks like they may start to move the football, a miscommunication on the snap. And the Lakewood Spartans will take over an excellent field position, first and 10 at the Pinellas Park 45.
Well, that's the second time that's happened. Remember, that happened to Booker near the goal line earlier. This time he can't get away with it, and the Spartans recover.
And that one didn't even come up into his hands. It came up and hit him in the chest, in the wishbone. Swain spread to the short side of the field. This is number three on the counter. Nothing there. He's stuffed in the backfield. Number three is Mark Cruz. Mark is a senior running back. Coach Stevens said, we're going to play a lot of people, and they have. They've run a lot of backs in, a lot of defensive players. Running players in at the wide receiver position. This is 17, Eric Marshall now, replacing Swain, bringing the play in from the bench.
Sometimes when you do use a lot of your non-regulars, though, sometimes that can happen, the miscommunication, and can disrupt the play like that.
Going to break the bone and go to the I formation. Floyd and Fletcher are the backs. Wide receiver either side. This is Fletcher trying to get outside. Cuts it back. Good hard running by Fletcher. Will be very close to a first down. Looked like he was going to be stopped about 5 yards shy of that, Mike, but he has that good intuition of just keeping those legs turning and finding that little extra bit of yardage across the middle.
That's true of all these Lakewood running backs. They're not that big, but they've got good quickness and good strength, good lower body strength that enables them to break tackles.
Nothing fancy.
Fletcher
just the pitch.
Cuts it back inside, and you can see him continue to fight, and he's very just shy of first down.
Officials timeout for the measurement. Fletcher on the sideline getting a breather after that tough run. Swain comes back in, number 8 at the wide receiver position, bringing play in from the bench. Be a half a yard shot. It'll be third down. Call it the length of the football. Wide slot to the left and a wide slot to the right. One running back is Floyd. He'll give him the ball up the middle. He'll have his first down and then some. He'll be inside the 35. It'll be first and 10 from the 32 of Pinellas Park. That time, Mike, they sent the receivers way wide out, trying to spread the defense out and set the big guy straight up the middle.
They've done that a number of times. Remember, they mantled the wishbone and had two wide receivers out as Floyd picked up that long gain that was later nullified by a penalty. So what you see isn't usually what you get with this Lakewood offense.
Jason Fletcher has checked back in. Running back position. It's Fletcher on the counter, breaking it to the outside, up the middle. He's going to take it for the touchdown. Jason Fletcher, 32 yards, some nifty cutback running. We'll take it for the touchdown, 19-6 Lakewood here in the second quarter. Looks like they're going to call it back, Mike, and they are. Spoke prematurely. They have a flag on the opposite side of the field on the 15-yard line. They're going to call an illegal block, but it still does not take anything away from that effort by Jason Fletcher. He is an exciting senior running back.
You know what I think happened on that play, Brian? Number three, Mark Cruz, as we see the call here, holding against the Spartans. Cruz appeared to move off sides, but he got back, and that may have caused the Patriot defense to relax a little bit. Fletcher is up here, and he brings it off for the touchdown, but couldn't quite see the hold there in that picture.
It was off to the right, but again, it was hard to see whether it was a hold. That marks them back. It'll be first down now. From the spot of the infraction, it'll be first down and 6. Ball at the 28-yard line. Carter's going to take it himself. Trying to get the outside, gets across the 25, will pick up 3 yards. And that'll bring up second and 3. There's a flag. There's a couple of flags on the play. We'll wait for the indication. A lot of flags here lately, Mike, in the second quarter of this game. And there's a clip, and that's going to march Lakewood back even further. They had an excellent field position. Here it is again.
I think it comes near the end of this play. Difficult to see right there, but another costly penalty. One wiped out a touchdown, and now they're well out of field goal range.
Wiped out a 32-yard touchdown by Jason Fletcher. That would have been his fourth touchdown of the year. And timeout, Lakewood. Midway into the second quarter, Lakewood leads Pinellas Park by the score of 13-7. Booker opened the scoring with a one-yard run for Pinellas Park. The extra point by Gressinger was good. Franklin answered back with a 96-yard kickoff return on the ensuing kickoff. The extra point was good by Dobbs, and it was 7-7. Second quarter, Carter with a one-yard run made it 13-7. The extra point, the snap was fumbled, and that's where we stand right now here in the second quarter. Physically speaking, you can join psychic Linda West. She'll welcome interesting guests and answer your personal and metaphysical questions each Monday live at 8 p.m. on WBC TV Channel 9. And Ebony Visions with Tina Middleton each Saturday at 4 p.m. right here on WBC TV Channel 9. It'll be first down, and we'll call it 18. Again, the penalty coming from the spot of the infraction. In the wishbone, wide receiver to either side. This is Swain. Looked like he was going to throw a halfback pass, but he fumbles the ball and falls on it, and he'll lose an additional 6 yards on that play. At 15, breaking out from the left side on a post pattern. That is Michael Allen. He's running it a little deep. Mikey bent it back a little bit, so it looked like it may have been being set up as a halfback pass.
And Swain may have been looking at the receivers downfield instead of looking the ball into his hands. That may have been the reason why he dropped it, as we'll take a look at it again. Maybe it appeared he was looking a bit further ahead. He dropped it, but good break for Lakewood to get the ball back.
Second down and 23. This is Floyd. Penetration trying to cut it back, nothing there. First man there for Pinellas Park, 56, Frank Colston. And he had a whole lot of help on the left side of that defensive front. Also over there was 46, Troy Lassiter, the middle linebacker. It's going to set up third down and 23, and we'll have another timeout called here by Lakewood High. This is two consecutive timeouts. They are not conceding anything here, even though it's third down and 23. They want to get some more points on the board. Of course, right now, we don't know yet which game we're going to bring our fans next week here on Vision Cable on the game of the week. We're going to check after this weekend and see which is the best available matchup. Mike Rhodes will announce that Monday night on Sports Beat. So tune into that show, and you can see which game we will be doing next weekend, along with seeing highlights of this game. If you're watching this game on Friday night on Vision Cable, of course, you can see it again noon on Saturday and 8:30 on Wednesday. And also, I'd like to welcome our viewers again down at Paragon. They can see it 1 o'clock each Sunday, our game of the week here on Vision Cable. Again, thank Paul Tanofsky and Jack Taylor. Now you see Jack Hartman with Kids Place Monday and Thursday at 3 p.m. and Saturday at 10 a.m. right here on Channel 9, one of the finer local kids programs in the country. Third down and 23. Carter wants a throwback, has a man out there deep. It's Fletcher, will come back and get the football, has his first down and more. He's going to be inside the 10, only first in goal from the 8. A very well-designed play. They rolled out. They had Carter coming back on a post pattern, a throwback. He didn't get it out there quite far enough, Mike, for the touchdown, but he got it up in the air, and Fletcher, with a great ball adjustment, came back and got it, giving his team a first and goal.
Carter's under some pressure here. He throws it off his back foot, but it's good enough. It gets to Fletcher. He comes back, makes this nice move, and now the Spartans well inside field goal range.
And with the formation there, they had Fletcher isolated against a linebacker, Jaeger. This is Floyd off the left side, driving forward. He's down to about the five. And anytime you get a running back isolated one-on-one against a linebacker, it's an unfair matchup for the linebacker. And that time it paid off for the Lakewood Spartans. The timeout, as we mentioned, they weren't conceding anything. They called the timeout, set up a beautiful play, and executed it very nicely. Second and goal from the six. In the wishbone, two tight ends. This is Carter on play action, trying to get outside. We'll cut it back up and have another touchdown. Number five, Tom Carter, the senior, 5'11", make that junior quarterback, 5'11", 164 pounds, will score his third touchdown of the year.
Carter appears to be limping a bit off the field, but he's sure that touchdown makes him feel a lot better. What a great read here by the quarterback, Carter. Appears to be going outside, cuts right back and finds a big opening, and Spartans ahead now by two touchdowns.
After the extra point, let's bring it back one more time. We get Linda Banner too, and look at the block out there by the pulling guard, number 67, Bill Logan. Kick is up, and it is through. Rob Dobbs, the score is now 20-7, favor of Lakewood. And here comes one more time. Look for number 67 out in front. It's a good kick-out block, enabling Carter to cut back up inside.
Well, most of the plays, running plays for Lakewood have gone to that right side where Bill Logan is. And he did an excellent job out there. Now 21-7, Lakewood.
It's also mentioned Jeff Cameron in the offensive line, number 64, Chris Graham, Greg Cinnamon, Joe Clark, all doing an outstanding job, along with the tight end number 89, Norm Baldick. Norm is a good blocker as well as a good receiver. And now Pinellas Park going against the wind, Mike. Maybe difficult for them to throw the football. Of course, still very early in the game. We were in the first half. They're down now by two scores. We'll see what they try to do to come back in this game. Low kick by Dobbs. Come down to Booker. Cuts it back. And we'll get out to about his 29, where his team will take over from there, first and 10. Got to be close to halftime. Again, we don't have an operating clock. We don't know how much time is left in the second quarter. Pinellas Park does, however, and they're going to call timeout and talk about it, try to set up a play.
Well, this type of wind, the long passes aren't usually going to be very effective. So if the Patriots decide to pass, and I think they will do a little bit more passing on this drive, they're going to have to make the short slant patterns to either wide receivers or their running back. Sheffield is a fine receiver. Harris, as we know, a great receiver from a year ago, so their running backs can catch the football.
Of course, Jermaine Holmes, the fine 6'4 sophomore, made a couple of great catches last week against Clearwater. And we also saw Brian Stratton, number 20, the tight end, make some good passes, catches underneath of the zone on the 15-yard drag type patterns after the wide receiver cleared the zone. We'll see if they try to set up a couple of those here, or if they're just going to be content with holding onto the football and going back into the locker room to regroup for the second half. They're going to send a slot wide to the left. The lone back is Sheffield. On the draw, Sheffield. Nothing there. Good penetration, both by number 21, Patrick Rollins, and number 30, Todd Thornton.
Play never had a chance to develop the Spartans defense in there so quickly. Now Pinellas Park in a hurry up offense.
Two linebackers shot the gaps and stuffed it for a 4-yard loss at second and 14. Same formation. Booker, quarterback draw, trying to get up through there. Nothing there. We'll get a couple of yards, but they are not fooling that linebacking core. They are reading their keys very well and staying home. And that is the end of the first half with the score, Lakewood 20, Pinellas Park 7. We'll take a break and be back with some halftime entertainment right after these messages. Stay with us. Mike Rhodes, Vision Cable 9's fifth high school football game of the week of the 1988 season. Lakewood leads Pinellas Park by the score of 20-7. Pinellas Park will receive the second half kickoff. They will be moving south to north against the wind. They'll have the wind in the fourth quarter. Kicking off will be number 22, Robbie Dobbs. Line drive kick coming down to Vaughn at the 7. Fakes the reverse, and he's going to be hit and spun down at his 25. Big hit over there. That was number 68, Mike Griffin, 6-foot, 171-pound junior on the special teams. Pinellas Park taking over 1st and 10 from their own 25. They will line up with number 2, Wonderful Booker, the quarterback. Number 31, Chip Sheffield, is the fullback. Number 1, Rico Harris, is the tailback. 5, Jermaine Holmes. And 6, Roger Vaughn, of the wide receivers. The tight end is 20, Ryan Stratton. The tackles are Chris Hyken, 72, and 77, David Wade. The guards, 55, Adrian Samuels, and 73, Ron Hansford. Pitch the ball to Harris. Right side, gets about 3 yards on first down. The offensive center is number 53, Ian Mensel.
Of course, the Patriots have to get their running game going as well. Their passing game has been non-existent. Harris had 42 first half yards. Sheffield had only -5 yardage for the Spartans. Fletcher, 96 running, and William Floyd had 32 yards on the ground.
Fletcher had to take a 36-yard reception to put them up 1st and goal on a 3rd down and 24, keep a drive going. This is Harris on the counter. Nothing there. Stuffed in the backfield. Once again, the 2 fine linebackers in there. Number 30, Todd Thornton. And number 4, Jonte Edwards. Thornton is a senior. Edwards is a junior, along with Patrick Rollins. Those 3 linebackers are extremely quick, Mike.
Patriots, after some early success with the run, having a lot of problems right now. Good reaction by the linebackers. They got up to fill the hole. And now it's a 3rd and long.
3rd down and 9, a loss of 2 on the play. Slot to the left in the I formation. Booker swings it out to Harris, has some room. And dancing around, cost him his 1st down. A big hit put on him over there by number 11, Alex Jordan. Harris had his 1st down, Mike, if he would have just headed up straight up the field. Trying to put a couple moves on, and Jordan denied him about a yard shy of that 1st down marker.
I think we'll see in the replay that Jermaine Holmes, number 5, that Harris was trying to get out of Holmes' way. Holmes wasn't sure who to block, and I believe that slowed down what Harris could do.
Here it is once again on our field level camera.
Nice completion, but you can see Holmes appeared indecisive about what to do as Harris is stopped short.
Those coaches will tell you when you're getting upfield like that and you need to get to the 1st down and get straight up the field, do all that other stuff later on. It's 4th and short, and apparently they are going to go for it. They feel that they are down here by the score of 20-7. They have nothing to lose. I formation, 2 tight ends. They have a wing to the left. This is Harris into the secondary, has his 1st down. A gutsy call by Bruce Buck. He's come to win this football game. It's apparent here early in the 3rd quarter. It was 4th and 1 from his own 34. He needed to get across the 35. He said, let's go for it. Harris gets it out to his own 39. It was a 4-5 yard gain, we'll call it. Here it is again. Good blocking off the left side of that offensive line. Let's give those youngsters some credit. David Wade, Adrian Samuels, Ian Mensel, Hansford, and Hyken in the offensive line. This is Sheffield. Nothing there that time. Spun around in the backfield and dropped for a loss of about a yard. Thornton, number 30, in there again on the stop.
Sheffield has had 3 carries, all for losses in this game. The Patriots need to get some more yardage out of number 31.
Also, Mike Johnson, number 40, now in the defensive end position for the Spartans in there. Loss of a yard. It'll be 2nd down and 11.
I'm kind of surprised Pinellas Park hasn't gone more to their tight end, or at least more passes out in the flat like we saw to Harris.
High formation. Holmes spreads wide to the left. Bland is a flanker to the right. This is Harris trying to get outside. Good penetration and a good hit over there. 87. Lawrence Coles, fine junior defensive back in there on the hit. Drops him for a loss of about 7 yards on the play. It'll be 3rd down and 18.
Lakewood is a very difficult team to run around the corner against with their team quickness, as Rico Harris is going to find out right here. It appeared he almost had an option to pass the ball for a moment. That play worked for a big gain against Clearwater last week, but that time it was shut down.
Coles is lining up at a defensive end position outside. Third down and 18. Looks like they're coming on the blitz. Here they come. Booker straight back. Has some time. Has a man out there. This is number five, Holmes. He's going to be tackled about 4 or 5 yards. Make that shy of his first down. It was a good in pattern. Mikey turned up, hooked up, and got the pass there against the wind, but he was about 6 or 7 yards shy of the first down when he received the ball, and the defensive secondary closed in a hurry, keeping him from getting that extra yardage for the first down.
And this time it appears the Patriots are going to punt. Good completion, good looking pass. Holmes has it.
And a stick was made over there by number two. That's LaDarian Allen. Their fake punt, and it's going to be incomplete. Trying to get the ball over here to Lassiter. Again, Bruce Buck is going for it all here, down by the score of 20-7. Booker is the quarterback and the punter. Lassiter lined up as a blocking back to the right, trying to sneak out, and the ball went through his hands. Excellent field position for the Lakewood Spartans. They'll take over first and 10 from the 43 of Pinellas Park.
That play fooled absolutely no one. Lakewood knew it was coming. Gary Alderman, number 9, was right there to stick Lassiter. Even if he had caught the ball, he would have been well short of first down yardage.
This Lakewood team is very well prepared. Straight up the middle. This is Floyd off the left side, wedging forward for about 5 yards. On the bottom of the pile, Jaeger, number 12, also number 32, West Straw. Straw and Jaeger, two of the leading tacklers for the Pinellas Park defense. Swain comes in from the bench with the play, altering the plays at the wide receiver position. Coach Bob Stevens of Spartans. Now Fletcher is going to check out. Lone back is Floyd. This is Carter keeping it all the way. Nothing there. And he's going to try to get down the sideline. He's going to be out of bounds. It looks like the 38-yard line. The official had to run out of the way to keep from getting knocked over, Mike, so it was a late spot of the football. Looks like he may have lost a yard or got back to the original line of scrimmage at best. Patriots bring up third down and 5.
Patriots do a fine job of stringing this one out until Carter finally has no more room. And he clearly stepped out at the 38.
Third and 5. Vaughn was the man over there making the initial defensive penetration for the Patriots. Again, the lone back is Floyd, wide receiver to either side, double tight end. Carter will roll to the right. Penetration, throws down for Swain and just can't quite hold on to it. Double coverage, but he put the ball right on the money. It was big penetration by number 56, Frank Colston, the junior defensive end, keeping Carter from getting outside. He did a good job of turning him back in. That's his job as a defensive end. Carter had to pull up, but he put the ball right on the money and almost came up with another big play, Mike.
Tough pressure, but Carter gets the ball away. And very catchable ball. Not the easiest of catches, but now the Spartans face a fourth down.
Fourth and 5, the ball on the right, the left hash make that. Carter will bring the play in. Looks like the wind may have taken that ball just a little bit and sailed it back in. And tough adjustment there for the receiver, Swain. Fourth and 5 on the wishbone. This is Carter. Again trying to get outside. Has a man, and he's going to overthrow and had Boldick underneath the coverage. Had number 17 running deep, Eric Marshall, but he was fairly well covered by Ashcraft. And the Pinellas Park defense comes up big. After being held on the fake punt, they hold Lakewood, and they'll take over first and 10 from their own 38.
Here's Carter back to pass. Plenty of time. And just simply overthrew the receiver.
May have just rushed it a little bit. Threw it off the run.
Perhaps the wind affected that pass, but.
And that wind is a little stronger than what one of the piers make that, coming from the north directly to the south. Split backs, wide receiver to the left. On the counter, this is Sheffield. Nothing there. He stuffed the line of scrimmage. Spun around.
Of course,
linebacking core in there again.
Of course, one of the keys for the Spartans was to stop not only Rico Harris, but Chip Sheffield, and they have done an excellent job on number 31, who is yet to get on track tonight. Surprised the Patriots don't try to throw more on first down. The running game really has been pretty non-existent here in the second half.
Talk about that linebacking core, Mike. These defensive linemen doing an excellent job of stacking things up and enabling that linebacking core to make the hits. Second down and 10. Wide receiver to either side, split backs. Booker on the option. He's going to be tackled after a gain of about 2 yards. That's 87, Lawrence Coles. Lawrence is in a one defensive end right now, doing an outstanding job. 78, Charles Norfleet is in a one defensive tackle positions. He's making a lot of hits. Also in their defensive end is number 40, Mike Johnson. These are all players that were not listed as starters to us, and they are doing a good job defensively in that defensive interior. Third down, and we'll call it 8. Split backs. Comes the blitz on the option. Harris. And a good close. It looks like he fumbled the football. We'll have to see where it was recovered. They're going to spot it right where he was tackled. It was a good close over there by number 9, Gary Alderman. Gary is a senior defensive back. And that'll bring up fourth down and 4 in Pinellas Park. Here's the replay.
No chance whatsoever for Harris. One Spartan took him high, the other took him low. And again, Patriots appear to be going for it on fourth down.
They will go for it. Bill Logan, another member at defensive line over there, doing a good job. Defensive tackle position. Fourth and 4. High formation. Harris, left side, wedging forward, will be very close. It looks like from here he has it. It's going to depend on the spot.
Tackle made by number 67, Logan.
Good surge off the left side that time of the offensive line from Pinellas Park. Wade Samuels, Menzel, Hansford, Eichen in the offensive line. Move the defensive front out. Here it is again.
I believe he does have it, Brian, that final surge. And where they have placed the ball.
They're going to measure right now. Official in the way. And he does not have it. Just by the nose of the football. You can see right there, a game of inches, if you've heard it said many times. It proved true on that occasion. Looked like to me from here he had it initially. The spot, though, was clean. It was where he ended up. And the chain stretched out showed him to be about an inch shy. So Lakewood, 2 consecutive possessions defensively, holds Pinellas Park. They have it first and 10 from the Pinellas Park 48. They have a dead ball foul called by the line judge. Encroachment, they lined up offsides in the neutral zone. It's a dead ball foul, they call it right away. Now marks them back into their own territory to their 47. And set up a first down and 15. We are at least midway through the third quarter. The scoreboard is not functioning. 27, Lakewood leads. They have trip receivers to the right. The lone back is Floyd Carter. Trying to get the ball underneath the Fletcher, and he's just overthrowing it. He has that strong arm, Mike, but on these shorter passes, the ball just seems to be sailing on him a little bit and getting it a little too far up over the receiver's head.
Difficult sometimes as a quarterback to adjust with the wind, whether it be for you or against you. And he just overthrew his receiver. I think we're going to see more of a running game, though, with the Spartans here with that big lead. They just have to be careful to avoid the turnover.
The backs are Floyd, Franklin, and Fletcher. Quarterback is Carter. Second and 15 on the counter, Fletcher. Back to the original line of scrimmage and then about another yard. That'll set up third down and 9. He got down to the 46 of Pinellas Park. He needs to get to the 37 on this play to pick up his first down. Wishbone, Swain goes wide to the right, tight end to the left. Play action, Carter. Again, good defensive penetration. He's going to slip and fall, but over there, number 56, Frank Colston. Frank has done a great job over there, Mike. He did not start this football game. He's getting that good penetration, keeping that outside lane, keeping, making him cut back in. Quarterback number 5, Tom Carter. And that time he slipped as he tried to do it.
Even if Carter had not lost his footing here, I don't think his play would have worked, as we're, Colston is there, take my word for it, and Spartans punting.
This is Dobbs. Kick is going to be short and out of bounds. It's going to go out of bounds at the 38 at Pinellas Park. He hit it a little bit off the side of his foot and didn't get the kick he wanted with the wind behind him. So it's turned into a defensive struggle here in the third quarter. First quarter, both teams scored, 7-7 game. Second quarter, it was all Lakewood. They moved the ball up and down the field at will. Here in the third quarter, each team has had a couple of first downs, but then the defense has taken over. Pinellas Park trying to get back on the scoreboard. They have split backs. Holmes spreads to the right. Booker, quick looking pass, has his man. This is Holmes. Good catch, and he's going to be very close to the first down. A little play action, dump pass over the middle.
Good looking play for the Patriots. Pass right on the money. Nice catch.
Here it is again.
Play action. The pass is sharply right between the hands, and now second and short.
Hit was made over there by Gary Alderman. Look where number two was playing. That is Allen. He is way back deep. This is Harris. He's going to have his first down, but he was hit again by Alderman. Alderman showing excellent one-on-one coverage out there with the receivers and also the running backs. It's hard to make those tackles in the open field. He's got a nose for that football.
One of the things that disrupted the play, although the Patriots do pick up a first down, this pitch forces Harris to do a 360. But Alderman right there cuts down an elusive runner.
With Darren Allen, number two, the free safety, is lining up about 20 yards deep in center field with the big 13-point lead. He doesn't want to get beat deep. He's not going to where he's being, where he's playing. That is the end of the third quarter. The score, Lakewood Spartans 20, Pinellas Park Patriots 7. We'll take a break and be back with the fourth quarter action right after this.
It's Kenyon Dodge's 54th anniversary sale. Look and listen. New 88.
With Mike Rhodes, Vision Capel's fifth high school football game of the week of the 88 season. Lakewood leads Pinellas Park by the score of 20-7. They have it first and 10 from their own 44. Pinellas Park, and Pinellas Park trying to get the ball down to Holmes on the out pattern, overthrown by Booker. That'll bring up second down and 10. Actually, the ball is at their own 49. After the first down play to end the first quarter on the run by Rico Harris.
One advantage for the Patriots this quarter, they will have the wind. That should help their passing game.
You probably hear that wind that Mike is speaking of blowing in our microphones here. On the counter play, Harris stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Bill Logan has done a great job on both sides of the football for Coach Bob Stevens. Number 67. Junior defensive tackle and offensive guard.
With the wind, the Patriots having the wind, as I mentioned, they might want to try that halfback option play they used last week with Clearwater with that man number one, Rico Harris, because the defensive backs for Lakewood, they support the run so much, they're so aggressive, they may be lured in and they might find an open receiver that way.
Third down and 9, slot to the left. This is Booker, swings it out to Harris. Cutting across the middle, will have his first down and be dragged down right after he gets it. A real good close over there by number 11, Alex Jordan. Also over there, Jonte Edwards. Looked to me like Harris is going to break down that middle. Mike can get more yardage.
Good play by the Pinellas Park Patriots. Nice lead pass by Booker, and then Harris does the rest. First down, P. Park.
Jordan making that good close, and there is a man down on the field. Right where the tackle was made. It may be the man that made the tackle, Jordan. Very impressed with this Lakewood team. Mike, Pinellas Park, we know, has a good football team. They very easily could have beaten Clearwater last week. They played Largo very tough and beat a good St. Petersburg team. Lakewood has a lot of depth. They're running a lot of people in and out of this football game in the backfield. An entirely new defensive line on that last series of plays that we saw. And with this a break in the action, we will take a break ourselves. 20-7 midway through the fourth quarter. We don't know exactly how much time because the clock is not operating. A big third down and nine play, however, we do know that much. Pinellas Park has the ball. They need to get it going right here. In the shotgun is Booker. Straight back, looking for the screen over the middle, and it's going to be Sheffield wrapped up by Rollins. It should be pass interference as Rollins was all over him. Sheffield looking for it. He's not going to get the call. Let's bring it back. That looked very obvious from up here.
Sure did. He had him wrapped up like a Christmas present.
Oh, somebody just forgot their flag on that play or just blew it. Fourth down and nine. Give credit to Rollins. He was in excellent position to make the play, just made it a little prematurely. No call, however, it's fourth down and nine. Slot to the left in the I formation. Booker, straight back. Has a man deep breaking in the end zone. Bland, he's going to overthrow him. That was good convergence by the secondary. It looked like he had a step, Mike. He had a step on number two, Allen. But two of his defensive cohorts came over and helped him make the play.
They close so quickly.
Once again, excuse me, Mike, has held.
Here's the play before the controversial play here. Booker sets up the screen very well here, but Rollins had one arm on the back of Chip Sheffield. No call, no flag, and now Lakewood has the ball. And
Fisher was right there on the spot. Must have just missed it. I don't know. I don't think there was any. I don't think it had any relativity where the ball was thrown. If there was an illegal zone there for that kind of play, it was definitely a forward pass. March 5 yards. For illegal procedure against Lakewood. They also have a first and 15 from their own 24. Third time in this half that Lakewood has held Pinellas Park on downs. Wishbone. This is number 21 just into the game, dancing across the middle, back across the original line of scrimmage. Patrick Rollins, fine linebacker, also playing running back. He has it back across it to pick up second down now and eight.
Patriots now have to try to concentrate on trying to force some turnovers out of this wishbone, or they're going to go down to the field.
Michael Stover checking in offensive guard position. Also number 25, Reggie Franklin, checking in to replace Rollins at the running back position. This is Fletcher, cuts it back. Good running by Fletcher, has his first down. Impressive thing about Fletcher, Mike, and all these backs from Lakewood, they have great speed. But again, they're not trying to get outside on every play. If it's not there, they will cut it up and stick their nose in there where the big boys are and try to get up the middle, and they do a very good job of it.
And they're so quick at hitting those holes. Fletcher with 11.3 speed in the 100 meters, and they are really tough little runners, though, as we have seen.
First down for Lakewood from their own 41. They will be happy now just to keep the ball on the ground and chew up some of this clock and run the timeout here in the fourth quarter as they lead by 13. Franklin will get about a yard on the play. Good pressure on the right side that time by Pinellas Park. Lassiter over there. Shannon Harris. Colston. Number one of Pinellas Park Patriot defenders. Thing about this Pinellas Park team, they will not give up. They'll be trying to strip the football and trying to make a big play happen for this team. Second down and nine. Wide receiver to the left in the wishbone. Another dead ball flag. And it looks again like either somebody moved from Lakewood or lined up. Legal procedure. One of the linemen apparently moved. Marching them back 5 yards, bringing up second down and 14. There Left guard pulled up their hand, his hand a little too early. Good call by the officials. Trip receivers to the right. The lone back is Floyd. This is Floyd up the middle. Stuffed as he's trying to get up there, back to the original line of scrimmage, and that is all. Looked like 32 West Straw, along with Jaeger in on the stop for the Patriots. Back to the original line of scrimmage. We'll call it third down and 10.
Nice job this time. Floyd stuffed immediately and pushed back. Bring up a third and long.
Straw is the free safety. A strong safety make that. He's playing virtually a linebacker, middle linebacker right now, as they are not respecting the pass. This is Carter trying to get outside. Has Floyd in front. Makes a good block, and Carter, showing the athletic ability, leaps over a man and will have his first down across midfield.
What a big first down that is. It keeps the clock moving. Spartans retain possession.
Tom Carter, the 5'11", 164-pound junior. A good strong arm, also an outstanding runner.
Sprint out, and we're going to see him hurdle his own man right there, Floyd, and he gets the first down. Nice play.
And Floyd out there leading the interference, pushing a player out of the way. Got the job done for the Spartans. Same play to the left. Trying to get outside, and Vaughn spins him around, spins out of that tackle. Gets back to the original line of scrimmage in a yard, and a late flag will go down.
I believe we have a face mask against Pinellas Park, Brian.
Carter, two consecutive plays, running the bootleg to either side. That time he took it to the left. Here it is again.
There's Carter coming out. And right there's the face mask by Roger Vaughn, number 6.
Vaughn had him tied up and just reaching, trying to bring him down with the other hand. Got the face mask. March a big 15-yard penalty off against the Patriots. That'll be another first down for Lakewood. They'll have it first and 10 from the 33 of Pinellas Park. Officials timeout on the field. I believe that is, it is the 4-minute warning. High school football, when the clock is not operating, they'll tell each team when there's 4 minutes left in the game. Lakewood, first and 10, has a 20-7 lead. They are just right now trying to run out the clock in the I formation. Floyd and Fletcher are the backs. This is Fletcher. Cuts it back. Running hard, will be close to another first down, depending on the spot. I believe it'll be about a yard shy. Good job of downfield blocking by his running mate, Reggie Franklin, the man who had the big kickoff return in the first half. Downfield trying to block out two defensive backs, Mike. Nice effort.
Fletcher's the type of running back that always seems to be able to squeeze out a couple more yards even when he looks like he stopped.
Second down and 1. I formation, wide receiver to either side. Fletcher and Floyd. Fletcher goes in motion. Floyd has some room. Into the secondary. Knocked down, but not until he gets his first down. It'll be first and 10, Lakewood, from the 15 of Pinellas Park. We had noise in the background. I believe the helicopter from the Channel 10, Mike.
I believe it is, Brian.
See the replay. Floyd right up the middle, again spreading the defense out, sending the tailback in motion, trying to get the linebacker and Flo to go with him, and running the big fullback straight up the middle. My formation with Floyd and Fletcher. And another one of those penalties. Somebody is either lining up offsides every other play, or what's going on in that offensive line. That's about the only bad point, I think, for Coach Bob Stevens' squad this evening. They played an outstanding football game, but they got a lot of these five-yard penalties, setting themselves up in second and 15, first and 15, an awful lot. That's probably one of the only things he's not going to be happy with after today's game.
No doubt about it. It's been a solid effort otherwise.
Franklin spreads wide to the left, Swain to the right. Floyd and Fletcher are the running backs. This is Fletcher. And he's going to trip and fall, trying to get outside. It was good penetration. 46 Lassiter over there, forcing him to the outside, along with Vaughn and Harris. Pinellas Park will call timeout, stop the clock. They have the wind at their back. They can get this football back in a hurry. We've seen stranger things happen on a high school football field. But right now, it's all Lakewood. You can see body-wise with Chuck at Danilowski. Monday at 6:30, Wednesday at 6:30, and Friday again at 6:30 on Vision Cable's WVC-TV Channel 9. Local Look with Elaine Lucadonna and yours truly every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. Of course, one of the finer shows on Vision Cable's Channel 9. That issue with Jenny Noble every first and third Thursday at 2 p.m. on Channel 9. I have a lot of people in the truck that are chuckling over my editorial comments about Local Look. Inside Pinellas Park with Elaine Lucadonna every first and third Thursday at 6 p.m. We know we are inside of 4 minutes remaining in this one. Lakewood leading by the score of 22-7. They have a second down and 20 now. Just trying to run the clock out against Pinellas Park in the wishbone with two tight ends. This is Carter on play action. Has the corner turned? He is up to the races. It's a foot race, and he's going to be into the end zone for the touchdown. The third touchdown of the game by Tom Carter. He takes it 24 yards on the bootleg. Everybody went with the running back fake. By the time they recovered, it was too late. That 4-4 speed enabled him to turn the corner and get into the corner of that end zone.
No way were they going to catch number 5, Tom Carter, as he puts a capper on this impressive game by the Lakewood Spartans. The entire Pinellas Park defense shifted over to the right on the fake as Carter in there easily.
Robbie Dobbs will be in to attempt the extra point. Make that Jason White. Dobbs will be his holder. White left footer up, and it is through. With about 2 minutes remaining in this one, the score is 27-7. Lakewood over Pinellas Park. And Mike, I think it's safe to say now, this Lakewood team is for real. A lot of people early in the year were picking them to lose their first couple of games. Take a look coming up here on the replay from the end zone. Carter
gets outside Colston, and once he got past Frank Colston, Lassiter's not going to get him as he's in there for the TD.
Good look at the fine junior quarterback, played part of the year last year. This Lakewood team, really, they have a couple of tough rivals coming up in their division, but I don't see anybody on the roster, on the schedule here, that they will not probably be favored to beat the rest of this year.
The two toughest teams, of course, Southeast and Northeast, but those are not district games, and that's the most important thing right now. They are in the driver's seat for their district title.
And the short kickoff will go out of bounds at about the 30-yard line. Of course, Northeast is an outstanding football team. They may not be favored in that game, but the rest of these football games, they will probably go in as the favorite. Coach Stevens has his team playing excellent football. With the early season victory over Osceola, if they can keep going, they may win that division. Booker now in the shotgun. Slot to both sides. Straight back. Looking, has Holmes, and overthrown, almost intercepted, in and out of the hands of LeDarren Allen. That one was too easy for LeDarren. He was looking for the touchdown after the interception. Hit him right in the hands, and he couldn't hold on to it.
He still can't believe he dropped that one. He's just playing center field right here, Allen, and just could not hold on to it.
Holmes ran a little hitch and go and was open underneath, but the ball was just thrown too high. Send a man in motion. This is Harris. Booker under heavy pressure. Trying to get out, he gets it up in the air, it's going to be intercepted. Intercepted by Rollins, and he's hit and tackled at the 21. And that is going to definitely do it for this football game. 53 in there on the stop is Ian Menzel, the offensive center. Good pressure, however, by one of the defensive linemen from Lakewood. The ball was very much under thrown, intercepted by by Wound.
It was Mike Johnson, number 40, all over wonderful Booker, but Booker trying to bring his team back, trying to get something going, but he should really never throw in this football. Picked off. Of course, Booker just trying to get something going for his team, so it's hard to blame him really
too
much.
This late in the game, you really can't blame him for throwing that one. He has to make something happen, even if there's nothing there. Floyd DeLone running back with a double slot. This is Floyd. New quarterback now into the game is number 7, Marcus Powell. Marcus is a senior transfer here from Los Angeles High School. Man down on the field. We have two men down on the field from Pinellas Park. Jaeger getting up slowly. It's Gressinger, number 11, defensive tackle, and their fine kicker. He was injured last week against Clearwater. Getting up very slowly. Going to attend to him. Looks like he may have just had a cramp. He's trying to work it out on his own. But since they stopped the clock, he's going to have to come off the field for one play. There's no gain on the play. It'll be second down and 10 when play resumes. Convincing 27-7 score at this point for Lakewood. Carter with 3 touchdowns, a 1 yard, a 6 yard, and a 24-yard run, all on virtually the same play. The bootleg waggle type play. He's been running 2 of those. One is when he fakes the pitch, and that one hasn't worked. The one that's worked is the one where he has the good mesh between the running back and himself, fakes the ball into the belly, pulls it back out, goes to the outside, and that is the play he scored his 3 touchdowns on. 2 tight ends, wide receiver, either way, Floyd is the lone running back. This is Floyd hitting the backfield, trying to drive forward. Pinellas Parker's just sending everybody now through the gaps. Straw in there on the tackle, along with Blazioli, Lassiter. Third down and 11. And good to see Kevin Grissinger check back into the game as defensive tackle position. Double slot, again the lone back is Floyd. Picks the ball to Floyd. And he'll get back to about the line of scrimmage. Actually gonna be about a yard or two shy of that, as again, Pinellas Park is ascending everybody. And
that was a great snap count by the Spartans trying to pull supplies.
And that is the end of the football game. The final score here at Spartan Stadium is Lakewood 27, Pinellas Park 7. We'll take a break right now and be back with some post-game interviews. Don't go away.
Tonight's game is a high-power offense like we talk about. The Lakewood kids have only lost these kids that are playing now 2 ball games. One is a JV team and one is a varsity, and that's to Northeast. And that's going to make it interesting.
The intangibles. Now, the big story of the whole week was all over the paper today. The wreath sent by who knows?
Yeah, who knows? That's a coaching ploy, Jack, I think. You know, someone sent Lakewood a funeral wreath and delivered it in their team meeting.
The big one for the city championship. Our head referee, Bill Schertzer, and his crew. Let's listen to it.
Okay, gentlemen, let me introduce the other officials who will be working with me this evening. Mr. Beck will be your head linesman. Mr. Kayvac will be your umpire. Mr. Spankle will be your back judge. And Mr. Carlo will be your field judge. The scoreboard clock will be official. You're the visiting team. One of you captains is going to call it. I'll catch it like this. If we drop it, we're going to flip it again. Who's going to do the calling? You're going to call? Call loud and clear.
Yeah.
Call the tail? It is a tail. You've won the toss. You wish to receive? Which goal do you want to defend?
Kick it that way.
Okay, you stand in a line all here. All you guys stand in one solid line here. All right, Northeast has won the toss and will receive. Let's have a good one, gentlemen.
There you have it. The Northeast High Vikings will receive the opening kickoff here at Lakewood High.
And that's something that Jerry Austin likes to do. He likes to get the ball and go right away.
Tonight's game brought to you by Dr. Trevor C. Bevan of the Gulfport Foot Clinic, the good doctor, the athletic specialist in foot, knee, ankle, all leg injuries. If you have one, this is the man to go to. The good foot doctor, Trevor Bevan at the Gulfport Foot Clinic. And as always, tonight's game brought to you in part by Gulf Shore Sports Store. Since 1922, that's a long time, the specialists in all your athletic needs. I look around the stands. As always, I see the black and gold and the white and red letter jackets. That's right, they're in stock in all school colors. Man, they do look good. The perfect gift for Thanksgiving and Christmas. Go to Gulf Shore for all your athletic needs, whether it's sports and softball, football, basketball, baseball. I don't care what you need. They've got all the models in all the latest sizes, colors, and the best is the price. It's the cheapest in town, Gulf Shore Sports Store. Jim, there's been a lot of hype for this game now for weeks. I know we've been looking forward to it. And the issue of the week, who sent the wreath?
I don't think we'll ever find out, Jack. It's probably a parent. Could be with somebody on the coaching staff, but you never know.
Could go any way.
No one will admit to it.
I know Don Banks of the St. Pete Times might be looking for someone to pay for that bill, but nobody knows for sure. Tim Davis, Timmy Ware is back to receive the kickoff. Spartans 8-0 here at home.
And a lot of fine athletes on this field. Should be a high-scoring contest.
Robbie Dobbs will be doing the kicking for Lakewood. The long-awaited contest is underway. Nice kick by Dobbs. Be fielded at the two by Timmy Ware.
Good
to the 22.
Good covers by the specialty teams of the Spartans. Not the greatest field position to open up the ball game. The backs and receivers. You've got Jay Austin throwing the football. Fowler running. Ware receiving. Davis running. And you have the tight end Lee and the split end Greg Gaynor. Good looking group. The offensive line. Farr, Nichols, Dixon, McLaughlin, and Weddington. Good group.
On first and 10, it's Dante Fowler straight up the middle. Pickup of about four. Right into the heart of the Spartan defense. Todd Thornton, one of the middle linebackers, in on the stop.
Little power football wing with a tight end on both sides and just running right up inside.
This is a very aggressive and quick Lakewood defense. On second down, it's the fullback Davis, and he's wrestled down after a very short game, maybe one. Billy Logan, the big defensive tackle on the stop.
That defensive line is Coles, Billup, Logan, and Bulldog going both ways. And the linebackers, good ones. John Tay Edwards, Cruz, Thornton, James Martin. And the secondary, good ones too. Alterman, Kennedy, Allen.
Big third down play, first of the game, third and two. We've got flags everywhere. Easy hole for Dante Fowler after the whistle.
You can watch LaDarren Allen staying back 15 yards in a passing situation. Jay Austin will not be able to throw over the top of LaDarren Allen, number two.
Back up the Vikings, third and eight. Two tight end offense. Jay Austin fires across the middle.
Picked off. LaDarren Allen, number two.
If LaDarren would have dropped that one, he never would have heard the end of it. He didn't have to move, Jim.
A little flood pattern out there. Austin tried a little touch pass. A little too much air. You're going to see out of a wing, it's just a play-action fake. He's trying to drop it over the top. A little too much air. And an easy interception for LaDarren Allen.
Intended for Tim Davis out of the backfield. There's our first turnover of the contest. Spartans on the Viking 41, first and 10.
Wishbone look by the Spartans. A little cross buck to
Jason
Fletcher.
Pick up a five.
Lakewood offense. Tom Carter, Fletcher, Rollins, Floyd, Bulldog, and Swain, wide receiver.
Phil Garrett on the stop.
That offensive line, Stover, Cinnamon, Graham, Logan, and Cameron. That offensive line has wide splits, Jack, and it spreads out the defense. They break the wishbone.
Second and six. Handoff straight up the middle of the fullback. William Floyd has a first down and more. Dragged down by Frank Gilliam.
Good looking call. They break the bone. Now here's that defense that's trying to shut off the Spartans. Lee, Rivers, Swain, and Kenton. And the linebackers, Garrett, Barnes, Gillum. The three linebackers. And experienced secondary with Taylor, Swain, Macon, and Richards.
That's a good secondary. Both teams have excellent secondaries here. Vikings, I'd say, has to have the favor and experience. First and 10 for Lakewood.
The power sweep.
Hand off to Pat Rollins, stacked up, falls forward, he's gonna pick up about four. Again, Dante Gilliam in on the stop.
Wishbone look, but no option, just a power sweep to the left. Again, the Spartans are using wide line splits, trying to crack it back through there quickly. It worked the previous play with Floyd, the fullback. An equipment problem on the field.
Michael Allen in as the split end. He and Billy Swain will be sharing time tonight. There's a good looking ends right there. Billy Swain's had a great year so far.
And he matches up with Timmy Ware for the Vikings very well. They both have 18 receptions on the year.
What's really important is how far they go when they catch the ball. Both of them go over 22 yards a catch. First pass attempt for Tommy Carter. He looks, he's gonna keep. Nice athletic move. That could be a first down, depending on the spot. He hurdled a few defenders.
Wishbone look. Little boot action away from the wishbone. And Carter gets outside of containment, picks up good yardage.
James Swain pushes him out of bounds.
Tommy Carter's going to put a lot of pressure on the defensive ends for the Vikings. He's quick, good athlete. And if he gets outside of containment, there's problems.
All right, third and about a foot. Could be a trick play right here. Fletcher to one side. Rollins to the other. Only Floyd in the backfield. It's the handoff to William Floyd. He breaks two tackles. Another. Dives for the big first down, down to the 10-yard line. James Swain makes the stop. There's good, power running.
Good looking call. Two tight ends, two wide receivers, one remaining back. Give it to Floyd, and he was hit behind the line of scrimmage. The Vikings are going to have to wrap up on their tackles, or he's going to hurt them all night.
Three busted tackles on William Floyd. Tough man to bring down. 6'1", about 190-pounder, and a hard-nosed fullback.
He brings those knees up high, and you really have to cut those legs out to get him down.
We mentioned in the pregame show, Jim, tonight, we're going to see six running backs tonight sharing time, of which all of them average about 5-6 yards a carry every time they touch the ball.
Even your quarterback, Carter, is averaging 4.3 per carry.
Billy Swain, your receiver, to the left. First down, Spartans from the 10.
A busted play.
And Tommy Carter's going to lose a yard or two. He was looking to hand it to Jason Fletcher. And Rob Macon comes up and buries him.
It looked like it was just a reverse counter, and the back just didn't get up in the hole. And that strikes fear in the heart of the quarterback when he turns around and there's nobody to hand to.
First big test here for the Northeast defense. Statistically on the year, they've averaged giving up 10 points per contest and scoring 30.
It's the first time we've seen the Spartans in an I formation.
Pitch to Jason Fletcher. He's got Floyd out ahead. Excellent play out of defense. Coming up quickly is James Swain. What a play. He got around that block from Floyd, made the stop.
It looked like he was going to get outside the defensive end, and then your defensive backs closed quickly. Very good defensive backs experience.
No gain on the play. It's going to bring up a third and nine. Jim, we haven't seen the double twin ends yet for Lakewood.
We've seen just a bunch of formations from the Spartans. Wishbone, double twins. Now we're seeing trips to the left.
Trips to the left, and a single receiver to the right. Only Floyd in the backfield. Third and eight from the 11. Carter looks, lets it fly. It's caught by Swain at
good
the six.
Hit.
Hit backwards. He went down quickly. Great hit by Rod Macon.
Trying to hit the short man on the trips, just a little delay. Good open field tackle. It puts the Spartans in a problem right here. They're going to go for a field goal.
Some good defensive plays and a broken play by the Spartans. Setting up will be Robbie Dobbs, the senior. See if he can put the Spartans ahead. The snap, the hold, the kick, it's up.
It's no good.
No good, just missed to the left. A heartbreaker. Lakewood had its chance to go up first. Jim, how important is that psychologically to get on the scoreboard first?
Well, you want to get on there first. You're all fired up. Now the Spartans are down a little bit. They realize they didn't capitalize on a good drive. Now it's up to the Vikings to show that they have some offense here.
And knowing Jerry Austin as you do over the years, what do you expect this first play coming out? You know, in the first, a shocker?
In the first series, he came up with a tight formation. He's doing it again here. It's hard to open up.
Hand off to the tailback, Dante Fowler. Good spin, shake and bake move, pickup of 7.
Good power running. It looks like Jay Austin is checking off at the line of scrimmage.
Gary Alderman makes the stop. Comes up from the corner position.
When you let your quarterback do that, Jack, if he's smart enough, he can come up and he can see where they're overloading. The defense is overloading on one side, check off and run to the opposite side.
Second and a long one. Double tight ends. Jay Austin back. He lets fly. It's on the sideline in front of the bench. It's complete.
It's complete.
To his favorite receiver, Timmy Ware.
Another flood pattern. 3 receivers out. That time they were bunched together, but Jay put the ball on the money. He's got to keep the ball down when he throws it. If he floats it up, you've got too many defensive backs like LaDarren Allen who can pick it off.
Timmy Ware, an all-purpose back, running and receiving, 800 yards of offense, 9 touchdowns.
Timmy Ware is on the wing on the right side.
From the 35,
broken
busted play.
To Austin.
Hey, he makes the best of it there. That's a pickup of about 7 on a busted play. Lawrence Coles, the defensive end, wraps him up.
Northeast changed their formations around a little bit for this ball game, and they're going to have a couple busted plays when they do that. At time, Jay had no one to hand to. Intelligent young man just took off to his left, picked up good yardage. He's not quite as fast as Tom Carter for the Spartans, but he is a good athlete.
That he is.
Tight wing
junior
to the
quarterback.
Right.
Hand off again to Fowler. That could be a first down. Very close. Depends on the spot. You know, one thing both teams have in common, that is a first down. Both football teams have a lot of high school basketball players on their rosters.
They're usually the best athletes in the school, Jack, and you like to have them at your skilled positions. Defensive backs, excellent receivers, running backs. There's no reason why a kid can't play 2 or 3 sports in high school.
First and 10 from the 45. Hand off to Davis. He has blockers out in front. Big gainer, pickup of about 9.
Good looking sweep to the left. Credit the guards getting out in front.
That's Matt Nickel, the left guard. Jason Farah, the left tackle. And James Martin will make the stop.
And Timmy Davis for 6'195" just shows outstanding speed. He turned that corner with ease. Good looking drive right here, the Vikings.
Second and inches. Austin back. He looks. Across the middle, wide open. It's caught.
Is he going to? No. Are they going to give it to him?
Yes, they are. Timmy Ware wide open in
good
the middle.
Good call by the officials. It was bobbled, but it never did hit the ground. Here you're going to see Jay Austin pick up his 3rd receiver. He's rolling. He's looking to his left. He scrambles. He finds Ware. Good athletic ability right there. If you keep the elbows in underneath the ball, then you can do that.
First down, Vikings from the 26. Big first play right there. Hand off to Timmy Davis.
Again,
the linemen are up. Flags are down.
Now, when you find the flag coming from the outside like that, it's usually the wide receiver cracking back or illegal use of the hands. We'll wait and see. The outside receiver cannot block below the waist.
Had a convoy out ahead of him.
Now Now, with a new blocking rule, you can have your hands away from your body, but you can't reach out and grab. And obviously, that's what happened.
There's 3:10 to go here in the first quarter.
Have holding on the offense, still first down.
No score as of yet.
But this really hurts the drive right here. You've got big play yardage. You've
It'll
got
back
to make
him up 10. Northeast has to get to the 17-yard line for a first down. They got three plays to do it. Here's the fake reverse. Jay Austin has it. He's looking in the end zone. He pitches it to Jimmy Ware.
Good open field tackle.
James Martin brings him down for the Spartans.
That time again, good defensive coverage by the secondary of the Spartans. Jay Austin had no one to throw to. He had to scramble. He tried to just dump it off to a safety valve, Timmy Ware.
He wanted Ed Dillard on the fly pattern. He kept looking at him, but he was covered very well. Good defense.
You've got LaDarren Allen playing back 15 yards, and it's going to, he has good range left and right. It's going to be hard to throw the ball deep.
Jay Austin looks. He's in trouble, and he's going down. Another big loss. Billy Logan, the strong man of the defensive line, got through and brought down Jay Austin.
And this is something that Jay hasn't been accustomed to. He hasn't had much pressure during the season. And he's going to really have to pick up the receivers quickly.
There's a swarming Spartan defense.
We thought before the ball game that the Spartans had a quicker defense overall, overall team speed.
It appeared earlier that the Vikings were having success on the ground, but I think these last few plays, the momentum has swung over to the defense.
Tough call right here.
Backers in trouble again. Big trouble. He's going down. He's in the grasp. Eddie Dixon, the first of many Spartans on the stop. And listen to the hand that the Lakewood defense is going to get.
Good pressure again on Jay Austin.
Punters Kevin Schoenrock, Billy Swain will receive at the 20. High snap. Good kick, though, by Schoenrock. It's going to bounce.
It's good roll all the way down to the four-yard line.
Not much Billy Swain could do, Jim. He was handcuffed. The defense was right on him.
And that puts the Spartans in the hole.
What do the coaches teach those punt returners? What are their first reads?
Well, the first thing, you have to catch the football, but there has to be an up back telling you to either let it go or catch it, because you're eyeing the football. You can't look at the people coming down. That time there was a lack of communication for the up, from the up back.
46-yard punt for Kevin Schoenrock. Here to double twins on offense, they hand to William Floyd. He busts one tackle, falls forward, gain of about three.
Well, that's a play that we've seen quite often against Southeast and against Osceola. They go double twins, and then they give it to Floyd up inside.
Mike Barnes in on the stop. Unfortunately for the Spartans, Jerry Austin and his coaching staff saw the replays of that particular formation, so that they know what could happen if they don't throw the ball. Trip receivers, a handoff to Jason Fletcher.
Little cross buck, they broke the bone. They had the fullback and the tailback in there. Just a little cross buck action and good tackling by the linebackers.
In particular, Dante Gilliam. He had a big outing last week against St. Pete High.
He's a good athlete. He reads well and he tackles well. And he's going to have to against the Spartans.
And that's the end of our first quarter. So far, it's been all defense. We are scoreless after one. We'll be right back.
Makes the trips to the right.
They hand off to the fullback. They were keying on him, that whole defensive interior, keying on William Floyd.
You have to, after looking at two films, Jack, every time they go into double twins and have Floyd line up close to the quarterback, he's getting the ball 90% of the time. That motion just didn't fool anybody.
Todd Rivers makes the stop for the Vikings. That's going to force Lakewood to punt. Going back in his own end zone is Jason White, the senior kicker.
And this should give the Vikings just great field position, which they have not had in this ball game.
Timmy Davis and Timmy Ware at midfield to field this punt.
White has a good leg.
Jim, does the scoreless first quarter surprise you?
I thought somebody might break one early, but they're playing very conservative football.
Good snap, good punt. It's going to bounce straight up in the air. So the Vikings will get it inside of Lakewood territory at the 47.
And I think they're going to go back and they're going to try to pound the middle. I think their game plan, the Vikings' game plan to start off, was they could run inside against the linemen of the Spartans. That's why they came with a tight wing and ran Dante Fowler inside.
Ed Dillard, your receiver, to the left. Tonight's winner, that's right, will clinch the city championship. Dante Fowler, look at that run, close to a first down. Dante has 15 touchdowns so far this season, leading all Pinellas County players.
Smart runner, good-looking sweep, stayed behind his blockers, and at the last minute when they broke down, he just darted out. Good-looking play.
Northeast playing for its third city championship. Second and inches. Hand off to Davis. Should be enough. Jonte Edwards in on the stop.
Just a counter dive. Not very much there. Good defense by the Spartans. Edwards, 5'9", 162.
Let's talk offensive passing strategy. Spartans line up sometimes in a 4-4, 6-2, whatever, if they creep up. That leaves three men back, and you have that safety 15 yards back. What kind of strategy after this play? We'll talk about passing strategy. First down.
Sweep again.
Timmy Ware. Still loose. Nice gain. Pickup of 7. Coles on the stop.
They tried the Vikings tried the inside in the first quarter. Now they're trying the sweep. And right now the sweep is working. Passing-wise, the Vikings do not have a sharp break-off-type patterns for the receivers. Everything is a flow-type, flood-type pattern where Jay Austin gets a chance to read. The problem is you've got quick defensive ends putting pressure on it.
Fowler again gets around the end. Breaks the tackle and lunges for a first down. Down to the 25-yard line, Todd Thornton, the linebacker, makes the stop.
You're getting good crackback blocking by the wide receivers, and they're smart. They're not coming in and hitting. They're just screening. It's like a pick in basketball. You wait until the man turns around. You step in front of him. That's letting them get outside.
9:18 now left in the first half. We're still scoreless at Lakewood.
Double reverse inside. Timmy Ware.
Well defensed. Short yardage. Lawrence Coles again makes the stop. Let's give the Vikings 5 yards.
That's a nice looking double reverse, Jack. You have to remember on that double reverse that Jay Austin trails the play after handing it off. Timmy Ware can pitch the ball if he's capable to Jay Austin, the quarterback, on an option look on that double reverse.
Spot the ball at the 20. Deepest drive for the Vikings so far. Timmy Davis in trouble. He's lassoed and taken to the turf. Mike Johnson on the stop.
Mike Johnson did a good job of really guessing on that.
Eddie Dixon as well. So that's twice now the Vikings have got down to the 20 and then had a bad play. Lost yardage.
You can't go to the well too often. I know it's an old cliche, but when you keep running the sweep and running the sweep, after a while someone's going to start guessing, and your tackles, your linemen are going to step and go as soon as they see somebody pull. You've got to come back with some type of a trap up inside.
Jay Austin looks, fires.
He's open.
Complete.
Good hit.
And popped immediately by LeDarren Allen, but that's a first down. Timmy Ware in the middle of the field. Pat Rollins made the hit as well. Let's look at this one.
Here you're going to see a good throw off with a strong arm off the back foot by Jay Austin, but strong enough. Great hit. coming up, but a nice looking gain. Dante Fowler, number 16.
Inside the 10, Fowler again, nice forward. Should be inside the 5. It's first and goal, and Dixon makes the stop.
And on that pass play, Jack, we saw the strength of Jay Austin's arm. He actually was off his back foot, his right foot, and he fired the ball 20 yards down the field on the money. I think those Viking receivers realize, though, that they're going to have to hold on to the football. That was a great hit.
All right, here's the first real big test now for the Lakewood defense. The Spartans, on the average, have given up only 8 points a contest. We are scoreless with 7.5. We'll be right back right after this. Goal from the 4 for the Vikings. Fowler. I thought he was going to go, but he was stopped immediately. Thornton and friends in on the stop.
Good defense right there.
Chris Graham teams up for the stop. Jim, let's talk power football, goal line football. Who has the edge in the trenches?
Right here, I think Lakewood might. They've got some strength. They've got Logan in there, who's extremely strong. And the backs for the Vikings, Fowler and Ware, are not real big kids. They're not power runners. Now, Davis is. I'd give the ball to Davis. He's 195.
Still at the 4-yard line, and there's movement. And now we have a whistle. You know, I wasn't sure if the officials were going to call that until all the Vikings stood up.
Timmy Davis moved but got back down.
Have a dead ball, false start, offense.
Coach's nightmare.
Drive breakers, I like to call them. And they really kill you. You don't like to give up yardage down there.
Freddy Krueger play.
Now, here it puts you in a situation where you're going to have to swing a pass, or you're going to have to roll out, flood an area.
Bring the ball back to the 9, third and goal.
You've got 3 receivers on the left here for a flood pattern.
Jay Austin rolls, he fires incomplete.
Dante Fowler had it in his hand at the 3-yard line and just dropped the football.
I don't think he would have gotten in the end zone, but they would have been a lot closer. Good defensive coverage right there. So now it's the Vikings' turn to go for that field goal.
And you know, Jack, I don't think they have any field goals on the year.
No, they don't. So John Buckles, the junior, will set up from the 18, a 28-yard attempt.
Tough game to kick your first field goal.
Snap is no good, but the kick looks good. It's
good.
Holy mackerel.
And there's a penalty flag on the field.
Marty Kennedy was in there to block the kick.
Now that was a bust. The holder didn't get the ball down until late, but it was a good concentration by the kicker.
I tell you, John Buckles kicked that right underneath Marty Kennedy.
And we saw a personal foul after the kick that should go on the kickoff.
Now the Vikings score first away from home. It's 3-0. Official explaining to Jay Austin what his options are. Sure, they'll take the points. Although, who knows? Let's see.
You've got the offense.
The offense is coming back.
Coming back on the field.
Possibly could
have a
be.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker on the defense, penalty half the distance, and automatic first down.
Obviously, it must have happened while the ball was still in the air, so it's a live ball foul. But a lot of times in a tough game, Jack, you don't like to take points off the scoreboard. You know, unless you've got a lot of confidence in that offense.
Well, an offense that scores 30 points a contest, you have to have good confidence in them. The Vikings, for the last 3 years, have had a great offense.
Touchdown!
Dante Fowler.
There's confidence in your offense right there.
And Dante Fowler gets touchdown number 16.
And credit that offensive line with good blocking on the left side. You're going to see a little power play. Good run. Not real great tackling.
John Buckles now for the extra point attempt.
He gets a chance to do it again. Bad snap again. It's blocked.
It's blocked. And you know, the only Viking that's probably not too happy about the touchdown is John Buckles. That was his first field goal of the year, but he'll take it. Great block.
They're going to have to do something about the snap, though. They're not getting a good snap back there. They're not getting a good hold.
Alex Jordan blocks that. So it's the Vikings 6-0. Receive Reggie Franklin at about the 5 amongst escorts. So the right decision was made, Jim, on that penalty.
You kind of cringe a little bit when you take points off the board, but when you put an extra 3 on, it really helps out.
And we will see what kind of factor it plays on the blocked extra point.
But this is early in the contest, Jack. There's going to be more scoring. There's too many athletes on the field here not to have more points on the board.
Nice kick deep down the middle. Reggie Franklin from the 6.
He stepped out of bounds.
Stepped out at the 36, but an electrifying run by Reggie. Pat Rollins chases him out of bounds. Finally hits him.
Jack, that's when you see depth. When you don't have to take one of your starting 3 backs, put him back there. You can put a kid back there like Franklin who can make that kind of a run. You see a good kick deep. They have a right return on. He starts up to the middle, goes to his right, gets outside of containment, steps out of bounds, and gets clocked.
Here come the Spartans, 1st and 10 from the 36.
Counter dive to Fletcher.
Nothing doing. Spartans were waiting.
Little cross action out of the wishbone. Take the fullback to the left side, give it to Fletcher back over the right.
Mike Barnes in on the stop. Also some help from Phil Garrett, 51.
Traditional wishbone look with the 3 backs back.
Mike Barnes, the middle linebacker. 2nd and 8, Lakewood. Fletcher.
Power football.
Again, he's stuffed in the backfield. Same player. Todd Rivers this time comes up and makes a stop.
Excellent read by Rivers, the linebacker. Power football out of the wishbone. No option. Send all 3 backs to the right side, to the tight end side. And great defense.
Vikings have some good linebackers as well. Phil Garrett, Dante Gilliam, Mike Barnes, Todd Rivers.
Rivers is playing down, and they're showing a 4 look.
3rd and 9, twin receivers on both sides. Ball's on the ground.
That time it looked like the center snapped the ball a little early.
Tommy Carter falls on it, but a busted play again. Hurts Lakewood.
Just an inopportune time for your center and your quarterback to have a little problem.
Davis and Ware back. High snap, but a good kick. Nobody can field it, so Jason White likes those type of punts down to the 33.
And again, not bad field position for the Vikings.
The momentum still is with the Vikings.
Sure, they opened up their offense a little bit. Went inside in the first quarter, came back in the second quarter with sweeps. The sweeps have been successful.
From the 33 with 4:39 to go. Vikings on top 6-0. Dante Fowler on that sweep. This time he goes nowhere.
But you see the flag down on the field, and that might be a face mask penalty.
Mike Johnson on the stop. Lakewood players don't seem to agree.
No. When you run the sweep, you're going to get a crack call every now and then. That's an illegal block.
Our referees tonight is Bill Schertzer's crew. That's Bill Kayevic, Eddie Beck, Gary Carlo, Dick Sprankle, Larry McDonald. Had a good year for the officials this year in Pinellas County.
Yeah, they've been calling excellent
games.
Have
a clip on the offense, still 1st down.
Haven't been involved in any real controversial plays so far.
And we really haven't seen that many flags down on the field during the season, which lets the kids play and keeps everything under control.
Vikings going for their third straight city championship tonight. First and 22.
Trap up inside, ball on the ground.
Spartans got it. Yes, they do. Alderman, Gary Alderman, picks up the loose ball. And there's the break the Spartans needed.
Quick trap up inside, counter action by the quarterback, and that's hard on the handoff. And that's up inside, that's Davis up there. He gets hit at the line of scrimmage, and that ball goes flying. Great opportunity for the Spartans.
Coming in for the equalizer. They've got 29 yards to glory. 3:53 to go.
Wishbone look.
Billy Swain, the receiver. Carter keeps. Not much
good,
there.
Good defense. Good contain on the outside. Force Carter back inside, and he's going to have to lower his shoulder. He tiptoed a little right there, and he's going to get hurt if he does that.
Tommy had a convoy as the play started out.
And credit that to the outside contain man.
Norm Bullock is the defensive end on that side. James Martin also, Mike and Todd Thornton. Second and eight. Twin receivers, a handoff to Floyd. Fights close to first down yardage.
Twin receivers, they move Floyd up again, ran him inside on a quick trap. And it's a good read. Good blocking by the offensive line.
Todd Rivers in on the stop.
And Floyd hits that so quick, it doesn't take a long block by the offensive lineman. They love it. You don't have to drive a guy, you have to screen him.
Third and one, same offensive formation. Interesting play right here. Pass or run.
He's got to get the connection there.
Floyd, he's through.
Same look. Same
inside
result.
Inside the 10. Tim Davis. You know, that puts an awful lot of pressure on the inside linebacking crew in there with Mike Barnes. It's tough. We saw Southeast have trouble with that as well, Jim. You know, the receivers are a good receiving core.
But right now, Tommy Carter has not thrown out of the twins. Okay, so you have to respect the run inside until he hurts you on the double twins.
Now it's Tim Davis in the middle. He's the lone middle linebacker. A lot of room in the middle. There it is, the handoff.
Good
to the
hit.
Big guy. He's at the 5-yard line. That's where the hole was.
They're not running right up inside at the middle linebacker. They're trying to split the guard and tackle hole, hoping that they can pick off the middle linebacker. Good pursuit by the middle linebacker that time.
Timeout Spartans with 1:48 to go. If you're a Spartan rooter here, that formation is giving the Vikings trouble right now.
That just spreads out your defense.
Well, you see the two linebackers, right? The outside linebackers are outside the tackles.
Because you know that Tommy Carter can stand right up and hit the quick slant with the inside receiver right now. You have to give him help.
Plenty of timeouts left. The Spartans have one, the Vikings three. Now, if you're Jerry Austin, and let's talk about defense. You're Jim Connellard, the defensive coordinator for the Vikings. What are you going to do to adjust?
Right now, you're going to have to play your normal goal line, Jack. You have the ball on the 5-yard line, and you're going to have to play man-to-man on the receivers, and you're going to have to play up tight. Your down linemen have to make penetration. Your linebackers have to make the hit. Now, the problem here is that Tommy Carter is such a great athlete that he can roll and get outside. You can go man-to-man. Northeast has great defensive backs. They can play man-to-man. But I'm not sure if the defensive ends can keep Tommy Carter inside.
We haven't seen the passing attack from Tommy so far tonight.
But it's second down, Jack. I'm going to go back to my fullback. I'm a little conservative. Floyd's running the ball well. I'm going to go back to my fullback.
It's a reverse to Carter. He's got a convoy. He's in. Great call.
Good call. Giving the ball to a good athlete. Your linebackers have to go with flow. The three wishbone backs going to the left. Carter tucks it, puts it on his hip, and he outruns people. That's all. Here you're going to see the wishbone going to the left, Carter going to the right. Just speed. And that's all that is right there.
Great play. And Norm Bulldog and Billy Swain out ahead of him.
Good call by the Spartans offensive coordinator.
Okay, here's the tiebreaker right here, and we're tied up at six.
A very, very important kick right now.
Let's see who will be kicking. It'd be Robbie Dobbs.
And again, it was the big turnover that got the Spartans back in this football game.
Senior place kicker put the Spartans up by one.
I think we're going to find that in the second half too, Jack. I think it's going to be a tight ball game all the way through. It's going to be turnovers that are going to decide. Both teams have good athletes. They match up well.
Nice snap, good hold, and it's up.
It's a hook, it's no good.
No good, so we stay tied at six apiece, the equalizer.
That's when your kicker rushes a little bit. He swings his leg. Instead of coming through the football, he swings it from the outside. He definitely hooked that to the left.
What goes around comes around. Both teams miss their extra points.
And this puts the ball back into the Vikings court now.
A game of follow the leader. Jim, this gives us the time to let's congratulate the Northeast High Vikings for accepting their bid to the Lakeland Lake Gibson Bowl.
They've had three outstanding seasons in a row. It's a shame that they can't get in the playoffs. They'd represent Pinellas County well in the playoffs, and they'll represent Pinellas County well in that bowl game too.
1:42 to go in this first half of action. Robbie Dobbs will be kicking off. Tim Ware and Tim Davis back to receive at about the five. It's going to be
good
Davis.
Good high kick. And Davis is going to have to hang on to the ball.
Got a hole. Look out. There he goes. Out to the 35, and that hole opened nicely. Gary Alderman sets him up, and Leroy Billups finishes him off.
And he did finish him off. Great hit.
Here comes Leroy. You know, for a minute there, that hole was wide open. Look at this formation already.
You've got a trick play here right away.
Trick play coming up. Side snap. They're going to run. Timmy Ware. Pickup of about six. The officials didn't like the play at all, though, did they?
The only thing that could happen, it looked like Timmy Davis was blocking below the waist.
You got it.
What happens with that call sometimes, Jack? You'll come out to throw a block. You'll lose your footing just as the official turns around, and you don't mean to cut, but you're blocking below the waist. The only way that you can go to the legs is if you start up top, continue with the block, never lose contact, and end up
with an illegal block below the waist. Still first down.
We're tied up at six apiece. Minute 24 to go.
The Vikings are hurting themselves, Jack. They're putting themselves in poor field position, which eventually benefits the Spartans.
With this amount of time remaining, I don't think we're going to see it up in the air. But you never know. Two receivers, Dillard and Ware. Jay Austin looks, in trouble. He's smothered. He wanted to go to his backfield, Dante Fowler, but he was covered well. And Mark Cruz.
What they were running right there is just a swing, like a one-man screen to the outside. Jay Austin looked. The Spartans had it well covered. He was looking downfield. He's got to throw the football away. He's not going to have that much time, especially with these speedy defensive ends.
Cruz and Johnson on the stop. Covered well.
Well defense by the Spartans.
That's Alex Jordan. On the coverage. Second and very long, maybe 30. Ball's at the 15-yard line.
Number 90. Ed Dixon broke the neutral zone, and you have a 5-yard penalty against the Spartans. Unless he was drawn off by someone. And the officials are talking there on the field.
I am sort of surprised by the amount of mental mistakes so far in this contest.
Well, you get that with a lot of emotion. You know, they want to win so badly that they're trying to get that little extra edge and that little extra jump.
Emotionally, I don't think we've seen a team that gets up higher than the Spartans this year.
And they have a lot of people that get in and out of the game, which keeps everybody's emotion high, because you want to do well and you want to be the big hit man or the big play man when you get in there. And that's a nice situation if you're a coach.
Hey, let's congratulate also. How about the Lakewood High JV football team?
They have it rolling. For 2 years in a row, they're undefeated, 8-0. They dismantled the Green Viking or the Green Devils last night, 42-0.
Take 11 seconds off.
Must be something in the soil down here in southern Pinellas, Canada. There's gold in the soil down here.
That's called speed, Jack.
Yeah.
It's speed.
Well, you know, look at the program, Jim. You know, in the last few years,
the
programs that have been set up in Pinellas County. You've got kids coming out now from second grade, third grade on. You've got football players learning the high school system.
There'll be 33 seconds left. We'll take 11 seconds off. There'll be 43 seconds remaining. 43 seconds remaining.
Math 101 here from our officials. We got it.
And they have a nice program down here on the south side, Jack. They've got the little teams that come up and most of the kids know they're going to Lakewood.
Last play, encroachment on the defense.
I like to see that because a lot of families really get involved in the junior program. I live over by the Seminole Youth Athletic Association in Seminole, and boy, all day Saturday, there are more families out there. Good experience for the whole family to get involved. The players, the cheerleaders, the parents. It's a good program.
We're having a little trouble with the clock and getting the time on and off the clock.
We're having a lot of trouble here. Must be a Timex out there.
This is what you don't like to see from a coaching standpoint, Jack, because your players are standing around. They're warm, but when they stand around, they cool down. And when you get that, you get injury. And you just don't like to see it. That's why you're constantly telling the officials, you know, move it. Let's get it going. But they do a great job.
All right, we're ready. Second and 25. Ed Dillard. Tim Ware, your receivers. Jay Austin's going to hand to Dante Fowler. Uses his blockers well. Picks up about 7.
It's a sweep that's been successful, but they're not going to make big yardage on it because of the speed of the Spartans. They'll string it out. They'll let you pick up 4 or 5 yards and then run you out of bounds or tackle you on the sideline.
Hit by Marty Kennedy.
To make the big play, you've got to run north and south. And the Vikings will come back with traps to do that.
And that's the end of our first half, no matter what the clock says. We're tied up 6 apiece. Jim, what do you think they're going to talk about in the locker room here? Do you think they're going to open it up wide open football, or is it going to be conservative here to the end?
No, I think they're going to go back. They're going to stay with their game plan. Both have been successful. Jerry Austin's going to tell his Vikings, you can't have the stupid penalties put yourself in a hole and win a football game. You can't cough it up. Bob Stevens is just going to say, we need the football to score.
Okay, we'll be right back. We've got some great special guests in halftime entertainment. Stay with us. To you by Dr. Trevor C. Bevan, the good doctor, the physician for the Boca Ciega Fighting Pirates and of the Gulfport Foot Clinic. All you folks out there who may have some foot problems, ankles, lower legs, knees, need a good reliable doctor if you're a football player or any athlete that's had a recent injury, want to get it checked out properly, I recommend Dr. Trevor C. Bevan of the Gulfport Foot Clinic. Give him a call. And as always, Gulf Shore Sports Store. The sports store, the oldest sporting goods store, the most reliable. That's right, the McKenna Brothers. They have it all in stock. You know, especially you high school students right now, you see all your friends walking in the halls with those dynamite-looking letter jackets. What do you think they got them? Gulf Shore Sports Store in all the school colors. I can't tell you how many black and gold and red and white letter jackets and jerseys club
ball on the ground. Northeast has 40 yards in the air to only 2 yards for Lakewood. What's the difference? You've got Northeast turning the football over, making the big penalties, and you have Lakewood who can't really get the football. I would like to see time of possession, and I think that Northeast probably has doubled time of possession.
I'm really surprised that look at the passing yardage for Lakewood. The recent visits we've been down here to see the Spartans, they've put the ball up early and often. What do you credit that to?
Good defense, but also I think both coaches are playing a little conservatively. They don't want to give up the quick six on the interception, and when you have those double twins and you throw the quick slants, if you make a mistake, Northeast has an experienced secondary. A bad pass is a quick six the other way. I think the difference right now, we've got Floyd running well inside, and you have Carter, who's directing the bootleg well. On the other hand, you've got Dante Fowler running the sweeps well. The Vikings have to get the ball in the hands of Timmy Ware. He's their big play man.
Nice, cool evening for football. Some happy fans cheering on the home team, Lakewood Spartans. A little bit of a breeze, but I don't think anything that you consider detrimental to either squad. Also, there's some other contests going on tonight. A few teams are looking for their first win tonight.
You've got
Gibbs and Bogey. Big game there.
Big game there. You also have a big one. St. Pete Catholic playing Clearwater Central Catholic. Neither team has a win, and one of them will come out with a big win. They're both working hard, doing good jobs, and they deserve a little extra credit.
On the field, the co-captains go out. There's Norm Bulldog for Lakewood. He's kind of outmanned at the moment, but I don't think it matters if you're only going to argue the toss of the coin.
And Lakewood will receive the football.
Our head referee again, Bill Scherzer, and his crew of officials. We're all tied up at 6 apiece. Both teams missed their extra point. We saw our first to start it off. It was Dante Fowler on about a 2-yard lunge off the left side. And Tommy Carter on a beautiful quarterback keeper.
Little boot action on the keeper, just good speed.
And there's last year's score, 35-7. Really doesn't mean too much this year.
No, it doesn't. Throw those old records out. This is a great ball game.
So the Vikings will be kicking off, back to receive Reggie Franklin at about the 5. He'll be joined by Jason Fletcher.
A lot of speed back there, but the Vikings are kicking that ball straight and deep.
All right, we're underway. City Championship on the line. It's going to be Jason from the 20.
Trying to go on the right return.
Ran a long way to pick up a yard. Good defense by the Vikings. Antonio Swain on the stop.
Now we will see if Bob Stevens is going to open it up a little bit, have Tommy Carter throw the football.
I hope so. I like that wide open football.
He can throw. We've seen him.
Out of the double twins, when they have Norm Bulldog do that delay and the quick cross pattern, that works to perfection. And here they'll open up with that offense. Swain and Fletcher will be to the near side. It'll be Pat Rollins. Not sure who the other receiver is. First and 10 from the 22. Hand off to the big fullback. William Floyd rolls forward. Antonio Swain on another stop.
And again, the key holds true, Jack, but the Vikings can't do anything about it. Double twins, Floyd's up close to the quarterback. He's going to get the football. They're almost bragging about it. They're going to give it to him, and he's making good yardage.
Well, that's about the 10th time they've run that play. They, as you said, Jim, I don't think they've thrown out of that formation yet. Here it is again. This time it's Eric Marshall and Pat Rollins. Single back, second down. In motion, Fletcher. Whistles everywhere.
A little delay of game action, I think, here.
Took a little too long to get that play in and execute it.
That's what's really tough, Jack. You call the play, the play signal in, you call the play, the kids have to get out there for the double twins. Then you put a man in motion all the way across the field. Takes too long.
Second and nine for the 4A District 10 champions of 1988. What a catch.
Now it hit the ground.
Tough break. Great effort by Billy Swain. Let's look at it up close.
Right. Little motion to revolve the secondary. Quick hitch out here. And he was led just a little bit too much. The ball did hit the ground.
Let's our officials off the hook momentarily. Brings up a third and nine. 6-6, 10:45 to go in the second half. A lot of bragging rights here in this one. Double twins.
What?
In motion, Rollins. Gonna put it up deep. Good defense.
Little mix up in the backfield, which screwed up the timing a little bit. Strong arm by Tommy Carter. Excellent defense.
James Swain plays some pretty good defense on Michael Allen, streaking down the sideline. You know, Tommy looked at him all the way. Going to bring up a punting situation, fourth down. Should be good field position for Northeast. Nice punt. And it's dropped. Look out, hold on. Who's got it? It's still loose. Spartans.
Spartans football.
Disaster for the Vikings.
That time, Timmy Davis tried to catch the ball over his shoulder. Just not a real good thing to do. You need to catch it coming straight down. If you can't catch it straight down, let the ball go. Here you'll see that he'll try to catch it over his shoulder, drops the football. Great coverage by the Spartans.
As Marshall fighting for it, and Jason Farr lands on it.
Right, credit Marshall. Good hustle coming down. Bone looks, sprint out by Carter.
Carter's in trouble, he's good. Going down. Loss of five, excellent defense.
Todd Rivers again, tripping up Carter.
With help from Robert Lee. A game of turnovers, but I tell you what, the defenses are making some mighty big plays in this game.
And right now, the Vikings are just killing themselves.
Second and long, double twin offense.
Remaining back deep, draw.
Draw to Floyd, didn't fool
hit
anybody.
Hit by about five Vikings.
Get down, William. Viking rooters love that play. Nothing doing, another loss in the backfield. Todd Rivers, right there for Northeast.
Good defense. Now what we haven't seen out of that double twins, Jack, in the passing situation, is the middle screen. They've run that successfully against Osceola and Southeast. Now this is a definite passing situation. Have to come out in the bone look.
Eric Marshall, the only receiver shown. They're gonna pitch to Swain. Remember, he's a quarterback, he wants to throw. Well,
he wanted to throw back to Carter, and he's ripped.
Good defense by the Vikings. Did not fool anyone.
And that was a definite throwback to the quarterback.
Timmy Davis makes the stop, but what, Robert Lee stayed with the quarterback.
But what I saw Bob Stevens talking to Tommy Carter as he came off the field. Carter did not go downfield. He stayed back almost like a screen. Bob wanted him to run down the field. He would have been open.
Another punt and a nice high spiraling kick.
Okay.
Jason White's kick will be fielded by Timmy Ware. Quick first step, Jim, out to the 12.
And again, not a real good decision by Timmy Ware. He caught the ball at about the 8-yard line. You like to tell your receivers back there, don't touch the ball if it's inside the 10-yard line. That ball had a lot of momentum on it, Jack. It would definitely have gone into the end zone and come out to the 20.
Timmy's shaken up momentarily. Jeff Cameron makes the stop for the Spartans.
And that's a man you can't afford to lose if you're the Vikings coaches. Timmy Ware is their all-purpose man. Now he has to come out of the ball game.
If you analyze the game statistically, both offenses have a lot of firepower. Lakewood averages 24 points a game and Northeast 30 a game. But the equalizer, the defense, Northeast only gives up 10, Lakewood 8. So it's true, the defense usually dominates the game.
Two well-balanced football teams, and that's why we have a 6-6 game right here.
Northeast High Vikings playing for their third city championship, and they're going to again get the accolades. As you see, they're going to the Thanksgiving Classic over in Lakeland.
Hats off to Jerry Austin for three seasons in a row with just 9-10 victories. Outstanding.
Excellent football team.
And nobody here wants to take the grab the momentum of the game and go, Jack. They're trading the momentum back and forth.
All right, first and 10 from about the 11-yard line. 8 minutes to play in the third. Davis stacked up by that good Lakewood defense. They play the sweep very well.
They do. That's because they have outstanding speed. They can react to the ball. Good team pursuit. You watch out for the cutback. It's hard to cut back when you're running a sweep. You've got to run to the sideline and then try to get your shoulders up the field. Hard to cut back. Now, the Vikings have gotten away from their power sweep, which is just a little toss, and it's actually run up inside the defensive end. They're trying to run to the outside.
And they're trying to do it against the team of the next few years, the Lakewood Spartans. They're going to be around for a while, folks.
Dante Fowler.
He's
and
tough to get
he's
down.
He's ripped by about four people.
Alex Jordan, one of the first. Mark Cruz also in on the stop.
And this puts a little pressure on Jay Austin right here. It's a third down passing situation, but it's deep. And you don't like a turnover here. This would be an easy touchdown on the interception. Need the big play right here if you're the Vikings.
Well, if they do throw the ball, I would think you're going to see something across the middle.
You're going to see the flood pattern. You're going to see the roll.
Two receivers to the outside. Jay Austin goes back. He looks. He's in trouble. And he goes down. Big pressure. Ed Dixon.
Ed Dixon, big guy, 6'4". And he puts on a good rush. And again, Jay Austin has not had that much pressure all year.
Vikings are not used to that kind of treatment.
No, they're not. And when you roll like that, Jack, you can't see Mr. Dixon coming from the backside. I'm surprised there wasn't a fumble.
Trouble, John Buckles or Kevin Schoenrock back in his own end zone. And we've got movement.
That's a 5-yard penalty, but it's not going to be enough for a first down. But it will give Buckles some room to kick the football.
Well, that is Kevin.
Have a dead ball foul. Croachman defense, still fourth down.
Kevin Schoenrock.
That's Schoenrock. Kevin Schoenrock.
Got to have some butterflies standing in your own end zone there. Billy Swain, I believe it is back. It is Billy. He's going to have excellent field position. He's at the 37-yard line anticipating this kick. If he can field it, the Spartans will have excellent field position. Good kick. Fair catch.
But like you said, that's good field position for Bob Stevens and the Spartans.
Inside the 35-yard line, the best start of a possession they've had so far.
But I think they're still going to have to open up just a little bit, get the defensive backs off the line of scrimmage, well, throw your quick slants, your post patterns, then run your, then you'll be able to run your draws.
This is great field position to do it. If it is picked off, well, the Vikings have a long way to go to score. Let's see here. Your twin receivers to the left.
We'll
hand off to the tailback.
Counter dive.
Rollins.
Good to hit at the line of scrimmage. Patrick Rollins on a counter dive.
He's popped. Mike Barnes, I believe, with a knifing tackle.
But Bob Stevens will take that 3.5-yard gain right there. That's a good opening play.
Second and 7.
Now I'm surprised that we haven't seen any option football from Tommy Carter.
Marshall to the right, Fletcher and Swain to the left. Looking, Carter lets it fly deep. Overthrown.
He just ripped that ball to the outside, and you have to think busted pattern. He looked like he was trying to hit somebody on an up pattern, and nobody ran the up.
Oh, well, back to the drawing board. It's going to bring up a third and seven for the Spartans. Norm Bulldog comes in with the play. You know, as much as we've seen Norm catch the ball this year, I haven't gotten to him yet tonight.
Wishbone look.
Tommy rolls back. He'll find Bulldog here. He's open. Overthrown badly. He was open.
What you're seeing out of Tommy Carter is Tommy Carter's a little too pumped up. When you get so pumped up, you overthrow. Bob needs to talk to him, get him to relax just a little bit, ease the ball in there. He has a great arm. He doesn't have to rip it down the field. He's trying to get rid of it too soon. He didn't have that much pressure on him.
That was a nice pattern. He was wide open. He was flying.
Good look. Good corner pattern by Bulldog. Looked like you're running the post from the tight position, then break it off on the flag.
Jason White will try to break this tie. Long field goal attempt. Kick is up. It's close, but no good. A nice effort. We're still deadlocked at six. We'll be right back. Vikings survive.
Little counter.
Dante Fowler, hot knife through butter. Big pickup.
Dante actually ran into Ben Gaynor, the tight end.
Did Ben, what are you doing here?
He's going to tell him that when he looked at the films.
That run got all the way through to LaDarren Allen, who's playing 10, 15 yards back. First and 10 from the 30. Hand off up inside.
Just a straight dive.
Fowler again, short yardage. Ed Dixon makes the stop.
That's one thing the Vikings do well when they run the ball. They find daylight. They keep their head up, they look for a hole, and then they hit it quickly.
Good line up front. Ron Dixon, the center, Dave McLaughlin. Matt Nickel, the guards, while Bobby Perry comes in. Jason Farr, Kelvin Weddington.
Good hit at the line of scrimmage.
Punishing tackle.
Just a little tight sweep inside.
James Martin with the bell ringer. It's going to be close, about a yard shy. Third and one from the 40.
The good job by the tackle and the guard coming around. But the defense is reacting quickly and closing in fast.
Defense is starting to be
goal line
very,
look.
Very dominating. Davis has first down and more.
And he almost broke that one right up inside.
That was Dante Fowler. Alex Johnson makes a saving tackle.
That's the problem when you jump into a goal line defense and everybody, 11 people are up close to the line of scrimmage. You break it and there's nobody to make the tackle. Good
Excuse
looking
me,
play.
Alex, that's Alex Jordan. First and 10 in almost to the 50. Power football by the Vikings.
Good hard running, but that's great defense.
Dante Fowler getting a lot of work on this drive every play. Lawrence Coles makes the stop.
The Spartans are creeping up their linebackers, their defensive backs. They're almost playing nine people close to the line of scrimmage. Got to find some way to loosen up that defense. You've got the corners playing up within 5 yards.
Austin goes outside for Timmy Ware.
Good
Nothing
pressure.
Doing.
Good pressure again on Jay Austin, but he's also throwing off his back foot. He's got a strong arm, but you can't throw from the back foot and get anything on your throw.
He was backpedaling when he threw that ball. Pressure by Coles and Edwards.
And that's dangerous when you throw it out there to the sideline against a quick Spartan defense.
Well, I tell you what, if it was online, Alex Jordan had a shot at picking it off. Third and seven at the Lakewood 49.
Little double reverse, ball's on the ground.
On the ground, I think the Spartans have it. I think Jonte Edwards fell on the ball. Let's see.
Now Northeast recovered. This is more turnovers than we've seen from a Northeast football team in in quite a few games. And I guess the emotion and the pressure has a lot to do with that.
That it does. Kevin Schoenrock back to punt. Look out. He gets it away.
Got a piece of it.
Might have been blocked.
Good roll.
Spartans do not pick it up. It rolls down to the 21. We're seeing defensive football at its best. It's going to come down to a turnover. Someone's going to make a big one.
One big play, one big turnover.
Our score is 6-6.
Right now, you're seeing both teams sitting back saying they don't want to lose the football game.
Right.
No one's taking charge and saying we want to win it.
City championship on the line. Twins to the right, single receiver to the left. On first and 10, a handoff to the fullback.
Little option look to
Fletcher.
Floyd.
Floyd out to the 25, gain of 5. Jeff Linter comes in and makes the stop.
I'm surprised that Tommy Carter has not kept the football in an option look. He can run, and if you're faking into Floyd and then pulling it out and running the ball, you're not sure who to tackle.
Here's a double twin receivers. About what we expected. They do hand it off to the fullback. Close to a first down. Might be enough.
Even though it's a key, if it works, use it. And that's what Bob Stevens is doing.
Well, they've been successful on that play. They've run it maybe a dozen times, but they get almost 5 each time.
You spread out your defense, you run away from the middle linebacker, and you need a couple screen blocks by your offensive line, and you have a big fullback who is hard to bring down.
Both secondaries doing excellent job tonight. I don't think we have more than 3 or 4 completions in the whole contest. Late in the third quarter, we've got a minute to play.
I think that's a respect. I think both teams respect the defensive secondary of the other team. They're afraid that if they make the bad throw, it's a quick 6 the other way.
Well, respect for the quarterbacks. Both these quarterbacks, Jay Austin and Tommy Carter, are 2 of the top 6 quarterbacks in the county. 3rd and 1. Guess who?
Easier said.
William Floyd for the first down.
And William Floyd was hit at the line of scrimmage, but he's just such a hard running back that he bounced off, picked up 3 yards.
Spartans have gotten a lot of mileage out of the interior of their offense. Center Chris Graham and guards Greg Cinnamon and Billy Logan.
A lot of time they're overlooked, Jack, because of the phenomenal athletic ability of the backs. But the backs have to get to the line of scrimmage or they can't run.
1st and 10.
Counter dive.
Hello, Fletcher. Jason Fletcher. There's a greeting card from the Vikings. Hey, Jim, speaking of greetings and wreaths, you think we'll ever find out who sent that wreath to Lakewood?
I really don't think so, unless, you know, the person comes up and just says, I sent it, and I think that you're not going to find that.
That's going to do it for the third quarter. We are still knotted at 6. Can anyone win this game in regulation? It's got to be the next question. We'll be back to find out the answer. Carter keeps. Doesn't get anything going around that. Maybe a
good
yard
option
or two.
Look, Cedric Taylor showed a lot of speed by staying right with Tommy Carter, right to the sideline, and he had no place to run. He couldn't turn upfield.
You've got to have a lot of speed to stay with Tommy Carter.
And I'm surprised that that's the first time we've seen the option look with Tommy Carter, but absolutely nothing there.
Big third down. Now they're all getting big in the fourth quarter.
Still waiting for that middle screen.
Tommy goes straight back, sets up, lets it fly down the middle for Bulldog. Overthrown. Nice effort by Norm there. He laid out like a swan.
For a big, tall guy, he has good speed.
He has excellent speed. That's the second time we've witnessed that. Not enough, though. The Spartans are going to have to punt the ball away again. one of these teams is going to make one big play, and then I think both teams might open it up. Uh-oh, so tough snap.
There's a tough one right there.
Great play, though, by Jason White. And an excellent kick.
And this gives the Vikings pretty decent field position.
Out of adversity, he prospers. Vikings will take over at their 37. You know, we were talking about earlier about basketball players playing football this year. And I think Jerry Austin got a big kick out of last year's team. Remember, the Vikings and the Spartans both had excellent basketball teams, but the Vikings went all the way to the state championship, and their whole starting team were football players that could bench press 300 pounds or more, and they physically beat up Miami Carroll, but lost the game. Tailback, Fowler, maybe a yard.
Tackled by Logan.
Billy Logan, talk about the 300 club and bench press.
Right, he's well over that. He's 380, if not 400 on his bench, and that's good strength.
That's phenomenal.
And he's having a good game. He's all over the field.
Two-way performer. Todd Thornton and Mark Cruz in the middle of that defense. Austin looks, lets it fly deep. Timmy Ware, he's got it.
Great catch. He was covered. He actually wasn't the man that was open. Davis on the sideline was open, but you saw great concentration by Timmy Ware, the big play man. Here you see a little play action. You'll see number 20 actually open to the sideline. Jay goes downfield. Great concentration. He was well covered.
He took it away from Gary Alderman.
And maybe that's the big play we've been waiting for.
Great offensive firepower right there. Nice play. First and 10 Vikings from the 25. Fowler, look at those legs move. Picks up about four.
Little divide action, fullback right, tailback left out of the eye. Trying to get the linebackers to step the wrong way with a fullback.
Lawrence Coles wraps him up. Let's see if the emotion carries here. Gets the Vikings into the end zone. These two teams on the average put up about eight touchdowns a game, but not so tonight.
Here's the sweep. Davis up inside.
Look out.
Good cutback and good hit.
Inside the 10, down to the 8. Big play. LaDarren Allen has to make the stop.
And Jonta Edwards. Here's a good sweep. He cuts up inside. Good cutback. And Jonta with a tackle.
First and goal from the 9. Dillard and Ware, your two receivers. Davis and Ware in the backfield. Inside it goes.
Crap.
Look out.
Up inside.
Fowler.
Touchdown. That's one of the first successful traps we've seen up inside.
He would not be denied. He carried Spartans into the end zone.
And credit the offensive line with a good trap blocking. Counteraction with the quarterback, just reverses out, gives it up inside. Good leg drive, Dante Fowler. That's why he has 16 touchdowns for the year.
That's number 17. The kick by Buckles. It's good. Vikings take the lead in the fourth quarter. We'll be right back to see if Lakewood can equalize. They lit a fuse to a big firecracker right here at Lakewood. Fielded by Franklin at the 10. Reggie weaves.
And he is hit. Woo.
Dives over the 30.
Number 22.
Rod Macon.
Rod Macon. This is one of the best hits of the season on a kickoff. Watch number 22 come down. It's a good run by Franklin, who goes off to his left. But you'll see 22 unload.
Boom.
Picks your perfect tackle.
That's when you need a good insurance policy from Eiler and Wall. 9:10 to go in the game. 13-6. Spartans should open up the offense right here.
Two tight ends, two wide receivers, one remaining back.
Carter hands to Floyd. Tripped up. maybe a gain of two. Good tackle by Jeff Linter.
And it's a good thing that he made that shoestring tackle. There was a big hole there on that left side. Now Lakewood has the backs that if they get a break, they can go all the way. And you know they have to be fired up. They want that undefeated season.
It's on the line right here. Undefeated season and the city championship.
Tommy Carter on a roll.
He's going to keep all the way. Nice dive, but a good defense. That hole closed quickly. I thought he was going to go a lot further. Swain on the stop. And Gilliam.
So four speedy people come around that corner. The only trouble when the quarterback keeps the ball on a roll, he gives up about 8 yards before he gets to the line of scrimmage.
That's a cornerback's nightmare when he sees four of them coming at him.
It's a defensive end's nightmare, too, when you
third
see
and
five
one.
People.
Put your money on this guy up the middle. Look out!
And the Spartans are fired up now.
And so are the fans. Charles Ricard makes a tackle.
The fans are trying to get the Spartans up in the ball game with some noise.
You know, everyone in the house knew William Floyd was going to get the ball, but they couldn't stop him.
And he takes off. He's got the greatest acceleration on his first step that I've seen from a back this year. He can really scoot.
Ball at midfield, 7.5 to play. Double twins. Carter again to Floyd, same play. Good result, pickup of six.
What they're doing, Jack, is they're starting off with Floyd to the right side. On his first step, he's cutting back to his left. They're blocking the middle linebacker and cutting back in front of the middle linebacker. The offside guard is blocking the middle linebacker.
Antonio Swain makes that stop. Double tight end, Rollins.
Left.
He goes up and over.
And he is hit.
Pat Rollins got off the ground, pitch up three. Ricard again and Swain on the stop.
Wishbone look trying to catch the Vikings off guard with an unbalanced line to the left. And here's a big play.
Hey, has the intensity picked up a notch or two here in the last couple of minutes?
And the hitting is unbelievable on both sides.
That's what it's all about.
I've got to go with Floyd, Jack. I'm guessing up here again, but the big guy is really taken to the line of scrimmage. I've got to go with the big guy.
It's
Carter.
The keeper, Carter.
Good hit.
He's got it. He's got the first down. Big play. Charles Ricard and Mike Barnes. That's the touchdown play, and they use it again when they need the big one.
Good call.
First down, Spartans. That undefeated string on the line. This is the team that JV went 15-1 as varsity. They're 8-0. They know how to win. First and 10.
Counter up inside to Fletcher.
He picks up about three or four. As our first little bit of temper being displayed. Robert Lee on the stop. And the Spartans are doing it on the ground. They still have yet to really put that ball up. Although the last time they put up those two incompletions, they weren't even close.
Here you've got, I thought first we had a timeout, but we don't. If I'm the Vikings coaching staff, I'm gonna call a timeout and try to calm down that momentum of the Spartans.
They give it to Floyd. Look out, he's loose. He could go. He's to the 10, the 5.
Touchdown.
Holy cow. Spartan Mania at home.
Just a good hard run to the right. Woo-hoo. A great cut back to the left. And just sheer speed into the end zone. Here you're going to see good leg drive, bang through the line of scrimmage. Up in here, accelerate, cut to your left. Good spin, and that speed right there, and good running ability.
Bar the door, Keddy. Spartans want a timeout. They sense there's not enough players. I believe we're too many players. Something's wrong. They want a timeout. They've got it.
Big play right here. With 5 minutes and 33 seconds to go.
throw out the conservative playbook now.
And Tommy Carter comes back in the game.
It's 13-12 Northeast. Spartans need the big extra point.
This is surprising right here. If it's a tie ball game, you go into overtime. If you run the ball and you don't make it, then you're in the hole. This is a tough call, a gutsy call by Bob Stevens.
There's 5:33 remaining in this game. So both teams should have an opportunity to get the ball back offensively. But you never know.
And that undefeated season might be riding on this call right here, Jack.
Gutsy call is right.
They still have a game to play. But right here, they're playing their toughest opponent to date.
Ball spotted at the three. Spartans are going for it. Let's see if they have that quarterback keeper again. Big play right here. It's the keeper. Didn't
and
fool
he's
him.
Not going to make it.
He throws it. It's intercepted. It doesn't matter.
Doesn't make any difference. Well, that guy's got a nice prance down the field, but that whistle's blowing.
Cedric Taylor intercepted it, but I tell you what, Vikings have seen that play. They went to the well once too often. It's 13-12.
Really a tough call, but it worked before. You know, why not run it again? But there's still time. The Vikings are going to have to take the ball, and they're going to have to move it down, and they're going to have to get quite a few first downs to eat up that clock with 5:33. Also expect possibly the onside kick.
A gutsy call. With over 5 minutes to go, they'll have another chance if the defense comes through.
With that much time, Jack, I'm personally not going to onside kick it. My defense has been playing well. They've been shutting the Vikings down. I'm going to kick it down. I'm
with a timeout on the field, we will do the same for this important message. He left to go for the championship. High kick by Dobbs, fielded at the 15 by Davis. Boom.
Good hit.
That had to hurt. Four guys hit him in four different places at the same time.
And that's a wise call. They kicked the ball to Davis, knowing that he's had a little trouble holding onto the ball tonight, but that time he did. He held on, he got ripped, and held on to the football.
Mark Cruz and Billy Swain, the first two Spartans to hit him.
And here's where the Vikings have to mount a drive. They have to hold on to the football. They have to eat up the clock. And you know the Spartans are coming. They're going to come at them.
Hand off to Fowler on the sweep. Nothing doing. Spartan defense led by Todd Thornton.
No gain. They might even have lost a half yard. One thing is when you run the long sweep to the sideline and stay in bounds, you eat up the clock. But you have to make the first down.
I would think the Vikings might stay conservative. They've got the lead. There's 4:35 to go. But then again, it wouldn't be too unlike Jerry Austin to put it up.
Here's where you have to have a coach telling Jay Austin when to snap the football.
Second down.
Trap up inside.
Fowler,
nothing there.
And now here's your big third down call, Jim.
Here's where you're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback.
Logan and Thornton team up to stop Fowler. Do you put the ball up or not?
Official timeout. I think what you're going to do is you're going to have a roll by Jay Austin, and they're going to tell him that the guy has to be wide open or throw the football away. The only trouble is that the speed of the defensive ends of the Spartans might catch Jay Austin from the backside.
If
his arm's up in the air, that ball's going to go flying. You know the Spartans are going to come after Jay Austin.
Timmy Ware and Eddie Dillard both to this side.
Three receivers.
Austin's back. He looks. He's got time. He's going to keep. And he goes down just shy.
Did not get the first down.
Good effort by Jay, but he's 2 yards shy. Mike Johnson made sure of that.
Here you're going to see a boot, okay, to the right side. Jay's looking, good coverage. He takes off. He's a strong kid, but he takes a good hit and 2 yards shy. Here's where you have to have good protection for your punter.
Kevin Schoenrock back at his 26. Good snap. And a nice kick.
Good high kick. Tonight.
Billy Swain. Oh, fair catch. Yeah. A nail biter.
I can imagine Bob Stevens was a little upset at that one.
Hang time, 4.17 seconds. That's major league caliber right there. Okay, the Vikings will have to do it defensively. The Spartans stand only 67 yards between them and the undefeated season and the city championship.
Double twins expect Floyd to get the ball.
They give it to him. Floyd, look at that move.
They're doing the same thing. They're cutting back in front of the middle linebacker. The offside guard is knocking the linebacker. Floyd starts right, cuts back in front of the middle linebacker and his left guard. That's a good-looking play.
Another tackle by Swain. He's been in on a lot tonight. Clock still running. 2:30 to go in the contest. Second and two. Double twins. Same play. Loose ball picked up by the Spartans. Bulldog
catches it in the air.
And he's out of bounds at the 40.
Unbelievable
opportunistic play. James Swain brings him out of bounds.
That time Floyd went to the outside of the tackle on just a dive.
Disaster
really fighting hard.
Struck.
Here you're going to see Floyd come to the right side. Good effort. He's tackled. The ball comes flying on a good hit right into Bulldog's hands. And he turns around and goes upfield.
First and 10 Spartans from the 40. Rollins.
Up inside. Counter dive out of the wishbone.
Short yardage. Clock still going. 2:07. James Swain on another stop. Clock is stopped at 2:07.
I have a surprising timeout right now, and I'm not real sure if Bob Stevens wanted that timeout. I think one of his players called the timeout.
Next week's game, another state-ranked team, the Shorecrest Chargers.
On their way to the playoffs.
Face their rivals, Northside Christian.
Now that's always a good game, Jack. Northside's having a rough year, but they will rise and play Shorecrest. A good ball game.
Well, we'll get a good look at some of those talented tailbacks, Alex Plumeritis and Bill Godfrey. 8 yards and 9 yards a carry. My goodness. All right, it's second and seven. Jim, this is shaping up to be just about what we expected here. Top-notch game.
Hey, you've got your twins, your double twins here. Fletcher's up tight again.
Let's see if they give it to him.
Floyd's up tight.
They do. Floyd bursts through.
And you can see that the Vikings have pulled out all the stops.
That's another first down, depending on the spot.
Jay Austin, the quarterback, number 10, is playing defense as a linebacker.
Get some fresh players.
You're going to have to need... Jerry Austin's getting his best football players on the field.
Third and less than one. Quarterback keeper, Carter. He's got the first down.
And he was really hit. He is so quick.
1:46. The clock will start on the official signal. And there it goes. 13-12. Northeast has a one-point edge.
Double twins. For Floyd the moment. Up tight.
They give it to him.
Absolutely nothing there.
Maybe a yard.
And the clock is running.
They did not fool the Spartans. Swain and Austin team up for the stop. As well as Phil Garrett.
You've got second and about 8.5. Floyd's up tight again.
They give it to him, spins and goes down. Now it gets interesting. Clock's still running, we're down to a minute to go.
59 seconds.
It appeared that Floyd was momentarily injured.
He must come off the field. If they called time, officials will start the clock. 58.
And that was an interesting play there. All right, we're down to 50
seconds. And I'm not sure how many timeouts that the Spartans have.
Ball's on the 24-yard line. That's a long way for a field goal.
The fullback is back. Expect pass.
Carter keeps.
I think he actually bobbled the ball from the center.
One of the Vikings indicating they have the ball.
Timeout, Spartans. With 35 seconds to go, the Spartans are down by 1 point.
Here's your contest right here. They're going to bring in their field goal kicker, Jason White. Jason's going to spot the ball at the 27. It's going to be a 37-yard attempt to keep the undefeated string going.
He definitely has the leg to kick it from there. There's no doubt about it. Now puts a lot of pressure on the center and the holder in this situation. The Spartans have not had a pressure kick all season. They haven't had to. But this is also excellent for the playoffs, Jack. This will help the Spartans in the long run.
The holder is Derek Thomas, the junior. And Jason White will attempt the point. The Vikings call a timeout. The icer. Let's put him on ice for a couple minutes. Let him think about it a little bit. Cool him off.
Let him think about it. Now, Jerry Austin's coming on the field. He doesn't go on the field too often. But he's got to get his people ripping right now. They can actually jump and not give up the first down.
1 point edge for the Vikings. Well, the Spartans have their chance to win the game. Great game for the city championship. Oh, what's nice about this game is whoever loses, it really doesn't matter. Both of them are going somewhere. The Vikings to their bowl game. The Spartans, they're going to the state playoffs. Another timeout.
Another time by the Vikings. Let them think about it.
And that they will.
And the only thing I notice out there, Jack, I'm watching where they put the tee. It seems a little close to the football. Now, you have a soccer-style kicker who needs to get the ball, who usually kicks line drives before it goes up. If he doesn't have it back far enough, it's easy to block.
And there you see the Spartans playing for yet another accolade. They're tied right now with the Tornadoes for the PCC championship. Well, I don't know how many more timeouts the Vikings have, but I'm sure Jerry Austin will use them. You're right, Jim. They are very, very close. 6-7 yards at the most. Looks more like six.
You want him to be at seven. Now, when he's at 6 or 5.5,
37-yard attempt. White's kick is up. It's good.
With 30 seconds to go.
Look at the field. Jason White used every last foot of that kick.
15-13 with 30 seconds to go. Does not leave the Vikings any time.
Pandemonium, Lakewood style. Holy mackerel.
Again, hats off to Bob Stevens, keeping the ball in the middle of the field with his fullback and his quarterback, setting up the potential and hopefully for him, the winning field goal.
Let's watch it.
There's
a lot
of pressure on Bob Stevens right here. He made the call. It's all on his shoulders.
You wonder why.
Let's see what he looks like. Okay, there's your kicker.
Jason White comes through big time.
A little excited, and I don't blame Jason at all. Pressure kick.
Okay, now Jerry Austin might wish he had a couple of those timeouts left. But That's easy to say from here. He used them wisely.
Here, I'm not going to kick the ball deep. I don't want Timmy Ware to get the ball. I want to kick it short, put it on the ground.
Robbie Dobbs. He puts it down the middle of the field. He's going to give Timmy Ware a shot from the 10. He dances. He gets around one man.
Clip right there.
They call the clip. It does not go the distance. 20 seconds left.
He does get out of bounds.
Not much the Vikings can do there. There was one man that could tackle him.
No.
They had a clip. Hope they'd get away with it. Didn't work.
Now, the only thing you can do right here is you're going to have to throw some Hail Mary passes down the field. Hope you get a tip.
Okay, here's where LeDarren Allen, who's been sitting back 20 yards all game, starts to earn his pay right here. He, Marty Kennedy, Gary Alderman, Alex Jordan. Now the work begins. Allen, 25 yards back from the line of scrimmage.
I want to get my defensive backs back a good 10, 15 yards.
Austin looks a little dink. Can't get out of bounds.
And he's still in bounds.
I think that was scheduled, Jim, to be a
little flea flicker.
Little flea flicker that didn't work. 5 seconds left. Spartans. Let's watch them celebrate.
Unbelievable comeback by the Lakewood Spartans.
9-0, 4A District 10 champs, city champs, 1988 Spartans. They did it in style. They won this game, came back and won it.
No doubt about it, and hats off to Floyd, who did a big job of running the football up and down the field inside. Good job by Jason White, the kicker. First real pressure kick he's had to make the entire season, and he hit it.
Couldn't ask for more. We touted it as the game of the year, and I tell you what, these athletes gave it to us. Great contest, an emotional bond burner. Our final, 15-13. We'll get down on the field.
Tom belongs to Jim Kelly, and he's holding a copy of the Sporting News, which is really the best way to follow football action.
I've been reading the Sporting News for 12 years now, and when it comes to inside information, this is the next best thing to a coach's meeting. The Sporting News, for total team coverage, college and pro. More football facts and stats than any other sports weekly, plus hot news of baseball, basketball, and hockey. Take it from this quarterback. The Sporting News is America's favorite way to follow football action, and now delivered right to your door at a 75% savings.
Call 1-800-453-4300 and get 55 big issues of the Sporting News for 4 easy payments of just $7.50. You'll save 75% off the cover price, save 50% off the regular subscription rate. So call now, 1-800-453-4300. That's 1-800-453-4300.
We're here with Bob Stevens after a tremendous victory over the Vikings, 9-0. How's it feel, Coach?
I'll tell you, it's the greatest feeling we've had in a long time. You know, we've been 9-0 before. We got to get the next one. That's the goal of the whole season.
Took a lot of guts right there at the end. What were you thinking at the end when you were down 13-12 and you were moving the ball down the field?
Well, when we were down 13-12 and we went for the two, I was going to go for the tie. And my offensive coordinator said, no, let's try to go for the 2 points. We tried to run that bootleg, and we did not have as good of offensive night as we could have, and we made a mistake. They just out-coached us there. When we got the ball back, I just told Pete that my offensive coordinator would get me down inside the 20, and I'm gonna put the game on a 16-17-year-old kid's shoulders.
And you also put it in the hands of the guy who was moving the football up and down the field.
Yeah, Floyd did well. Floyd did extremely well.
Did
he got
job.
Fired up about middle of the third quarter. And they just couldn't, they stopped him, but he got the plays when we needed them.
Second and third effort really got him down the field.
We needed to wake up about the middle of the second quarter. It seemed to me like both teams we're waiting for the big play. I mean, that's what it felt like. I don't know what it...
Very conservative first half.
Yeah, we were field position made us conservative, and timing was off. And, you know, when your quarterback's off, you got to go to your running game, and they did a good job stopping that.
I thought one of the big keys was the pressure you put on Jay Austin. You put some
pressure on him. We worked all week long just trying to get to him. What we felt is they have more weapons to do things with than any team that we've played. You know, we played Southeast, and they had two good runners and a good quarterback. You know, they've got three good runners, three good receivers with the same kids, so they'll tie it in, and the quarterback. The only way we felt that we could come out ahead was make him make a mistake. He made maybe one or two mistakes, and we sacked him a couple of times. I don't know how many.
Well, congratulations. We're looking forward to the playoffs, and I know you want to get in and do some celebrating.
I tell you what. Any of y'all want to send my wife flowers? August 7th is her birthday.
Okay, we'll wrap it up.
Coach, congratulations on winning the city championship. And let's also congratulate Jerry Austin and his Vikings. What a ferocious effort right down to the last 20 seconds. We've got two winning programs. You've had it for years. And tonight, the chips fell in your favor. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, for the two coaches and myself and all of us at Paragon, as always, God bless. Good night. See you next week. And wear your Lakewood button for the rest of the week. Good night, folks.